Make it Michelle's.
93.5 and 107.5. The Fan.
WIBC HD2 W298BB. WIBC HD3 W228CX. Indianapolis.
85% of the world's working. The other 15 come out here.
If you want to crown them, then crown their ass. But they are who we thought they were. And we let them off the hook.
I'm a man. I'm 40. I'm not a kid. That's not true. So get your facts straight.
What else do you want to know?
Playoffs? We'll talk about playoffs. You kidding me? Playoffs?
We couldn't do diddly poo offensively. I'm totally embarrassed and totally ashamed. We sucked.
We talking about practice.
If you call me Chris Everett to my face one more time.
Chris?
Of course, my opinion of Kinga's performance. What the f*** you think is my opinion of it?
This is the Dan Dockett Show on 93.5 and 107.5. The Fan.
Hey, good afternoon. This is the Dan Dockett Show. Hang on one second. These headphones stink. And they're cluster all bad. But I am rock and rolling, ready to go here today. I absolutely had... Jody DeCee wants to know if David Carr is still a fraud. I have no idea if David Carr is still a fraud. I don't know David Carr. I did not talk about the Colts or IU on the morning show because, frankly, it's time to talk Colts right here. I'm not going to go all bat blank crazy on the Colts today. I'm not. And I'm going to tell you why. You ready? Because I'm influenced by Hard Knocks. Sean, I apologize. The Dockett shirt was in the wash. I wore it the other day. It wasn't washed. I wasn't going to wear it. I apologize. We absolutely have a monster fish today, Sean Salisbury. Later on, I got some Colts talk for you. You know, I don't know if David Carr is available, but maybe. I have no idea. Wentz was awful. The pass rush non-existent. Quiddy Pay made a play, so everybody loses their mind on him. Good for the Colts, man. They're going to end up either 10-7 or 9-8, and you know, we still got the greatest roster and players. We got 7 Pro Bowl players. That shows you how good we are. So there you go. I'm rooting for the Colts, and I'm not going to crush them, but I got to tell you, yesterday was a very big disappointment. Yesterday, to me, was one of those games, I swear to God, and Lee and I both felt it as we've coached for a long time. We felt like they were going to lose the entire time. You could just kind of feel it. You could just kind of feel that this was not eventually going to go the Colts' way. And frankly, it was not a surprise. It was not a surprise that the Colts got beat because they were due. My East Coast office has been all over this. Now my Southern office has been all over this. All over it. There you go with that one. Also, today we're going to get into IU basketball, craps to bet. Horrible loss for IU basketball. And you could really break it down to a horrible loss for Colts when you have a chance against an interim coach, a team that's been a mess. Now they're not, but a team that had been a mess. You got a chance to clinch a playoff berth after coming back from as far as you came back, and you don't have the stones to go ahead and win the game. You could make the argument that that was a horrific loss, but the truth of the matter is this. The truth of the matter is it all comes down to next week anyway. I mean, look, I don't know about it anyway. Maybe they could have rested guys or whatever. But the Jaguars are awful. The Jaguars made a hell of a mistake getting rid of Urban Meyer and promoting the guys that caused the problem. And I'll get into Urban today. I'll get into Antonio Brown today. I'll get into these idiots that played for the Houston Rockets today. But mostly it's going to be Colts and IU basketball crap in the bed. IU basketball, look, I love you, Woody, but at some point you got to win some games. And that's a bad loss. Very, very bad loss. Terrible loss. It's not a loss that you should have. Everybody wants to say, and Woody said it on our show, you know, we're all learning each other. My ass, let's go. Pacers signed Lance Stephenson. The Pacers needed some juice. Apparently Lance Stephenson is that juice. And guess what? The Pacers lost again. It was really a horse bleep day yesterday here in Indianapolis. I mean, no lie. I guess you could say at least the Pacers weren't down 30 at halftime and didn't lose by 35. They played it and kept it to 4. But let's be honest, that was a bad day yesterday. Purdue plays tonight, and that's good. That'll be a win. But not great. 317-239-1070. Should I rip the Colts today? I don't feel like it. I think they're a bunch of good guys. I've become like all these clowns that work here in the media. They're a bunch of good guys. You know, we got guys saying Quiddy Pay's still a good draft choice. Okay, fine. But at the best you're going to do is 10 wins with the best roster that they've had in the fifth year. Haven't won a division yet. Now, that's all I'm going to say. I mean, you guys can say whatever you'd like. You guys can tell me everything that you would like. Yes, they're still going to the Super Bowl. Yes, they are. But the truth of the matter is they're going to get in the playoffs tomorrow, or excuse me, this weekend, by beating the worst team in the world. You know, and I don't care. Look, writers for the Star have become, in Danuary, so insignificant to me. I'm not even mentioning them. I don't care if they rip. You know, we all know they're not going to say anything about anybody other than Carson Wentz, because Carson Wentz is easy, so I don't care what's written about him. I thought that Derek Carr was good. We're going to have Reggie Jones, my friend Reggie Jones, who, by the way, before you lose your mind, is African-American. Reggie Jones is going to call in and tell the Colts fans how white guys kick the Colts' ass, white receivers. I said to him, you just can't go with Renfro. You got to give me a list. He gave me a list. So we'll do a segment on it at 12:45. Happy Danuary, everybody. Happy Danuary. Here's the deal. These are just guidelines. There was no, I'm not drinking except for wild card weekend. That means no wine at night. No after I go work out. I love to have a beer. I do. None of it. I love eating. I'm going to lose weight. I'm already down about 4 pounds. I'm trying to do this sensible, Jennifer. All right. I'm reading 5 books. I've already read one. I'm telling you right now, Kent Sterling's book, Oops, is great. Not good, great. Great. Fantastic. And we're going to do something nice for somebody. Now, I got in trouble a couple years ago because some dad hiding behind his kid's Twitter account asked me, why do you publicize the good stuff that you do? And I said, look, young fella, and it was his dad. I knew it was his dad, but people lost their mind on me and everybody got mad. But the truth of the matter is I publicize things because I want you to join me. So I'm going to tell you what we've done here in the new year already. We just mailed today what to me is a big check to a very good friend of mine, one of my best friends growing up. I'm not going to say his name. I don't want to embarrass him, but his wife is going through something horrible, cancer. They've got to go down to Houston, and I'm going to pay this check. Hopefully, we'll pay for all of their bills down there. It'll pay for their flights and their bills and give them spending money. And then I'm paying for a friend of mine named Dominique, not going to say his last name, who I learned through sister Kathleen. I'm paying for his chemo. I've met Dominique and his kids once. I want you to do something good for people. Yesterday, I tipped more than I should have when we went to dinner. And that's the kind of stuff. So do something. Tell me good about it. And I really don't need to hear, well, Doctor, you're promoting yourself. No, I'm trying to promote goodness in this world, in a world where all this negativity and all this BS seems to reign supreme. All right? A very good friend of mine who knows football better than anybody that I know said this early in the game yesterday. Carson Wentz knows his team isn't ready to play. He's too much clapping in the huddle. It reminded of Sir Charles. It's an outward sign of lacking confidence, and that's what Bill Parcells always said. Saw it yesterday, didn't like it, was alerted to it by the Southern office of the Dan Dockett Show, and frankly, I didn't like it. And obviously yesterday, it didn't work out for the Colts. You had a feeling it wasn't going to work out for the Colts. It was a great crowd. The crowd was into it, but it just had a feeling, and it started early. And there's a lot of things to blame. Wentz missing T.Y. Hilton, certainly to blame. Why are we giving the ball to Hines, not giving the ball all the time to Jonathan Taylor? Certainly to blame. Colts got some luck, too, to even be in it, right? I mean, look, the pass that got deflected for a touchdown, that's always a lucky thing. It's not like everything went against the Colts. Carson Wentz, no good. 16 to 27, 148 yards. Taylor went for 108. But Derek Carr was the deal. Even though he threw 2 interceptions, Derek Carr was very good, and I thought they were smart by starting the game by going to Josh Jacobs. All right, let's go to Steve. I'm taking calls all day. We haven't had enough calls on this show. What do you got, Josh? All right, excuse me, Steve.
Hey, Dan. Glad you let me on your show.
Thank you.
I just want to comment about I thought the crowd didn't even get into it until after the first half, it seemed like. That first drive that the Raiders had, there wasn't no noise.
Well, I got to tell you, like, let me address that, because I was there, and I got to tell you, though, I thought that the crowd kind of took, or the Raiders, the way they were playing, kind of took the crowd out of it. They were running with Jacobs. I don't know. I don't necessarily disagree with you. It wasn't certainly crazy like maybe I thought it was, but I thought the way they handled the opening drive with Josh Jacobs, Steve, I thought that had a lot to do with it. What'd you think?
Yeah, they quieted us right after. I don't think the crowd came alive until after they got through.
Yeah. Yeah, I agree. Appreciate you. Eric, how are you?
I'm good. Dan, how are you?
I'm good, thanks. Thanks for calling, and Happy New Year.
Yeah, you too, sir. Hey, I mean, I just wanted to add one quick thought about the Colts. Can you imagine if somebody would have said at the beginning of the season, Tennessee would win the division by two full games, playing half the season without Derrick Henry, and most of the season without having A.J. Brown and Julio Jones on the field together?
Yeah. That's crazy. Let me ask you a question, though, serious question. Do you think that Vrabel's the coach of the year? Think about what
he's
got to
be right up there, right? With what he's done with that team, with the injuries they've had, right?
Yeah, Zach Taylor was on his way out, apparently. Then, all of a sudden now they're winning the NFC AFC North. I mean, I don't know. To me, he's got to be in the conversation, I think.
I mean, they're just out there winning the games they got to win, right?
And you know what? Basically, Julio Jones was Andre Johnson here. You know, great signing when you did it. You thought it was going to work, and then he hasn't done anything. A.J. Brown's been her appreciation, and we all know about Derrick Henry. I don't think you better not discount. You better not discount Vrabel as coach of the year. Matt, what do you got?
I have to agree with you there, Dan. Vrabel's coach of the year.
I swear.
With them getting a one seed and missing –
They're playing for a one seed anyway, but yeah.
The Colts need to figure out that they don't have wide receivers good enough to run a pass-heavy offense. I mean, Pittman is the only guy on the roster who would start for another team. They got different receivers every week, had no camp for Wentz. They've got no chemistry. The receivers are different every week. They simply can't run a pass-heavy offense until Ballard finds two more legitimate starting receivers in the NFL. Now, that's not going to happen this year.
Well, hold on a second now. Let me ask you, do you think Paris Campbell helps that? Because apparently he's on the road to returning.
He's got 10 catches. I mean, he's got 30 catches. I mean, you can say he's...
Yes, I agree.
...first-round talent, but he's not a legitimate receiver in the NFL until he plays in the NFL. I mean, he's...
I agree.
You hate for a guy to be injured.
I know.
Doesn't make him a bad dude. You've always said the best ability is availability, and he's simply not on the field. Patman wouldn't make another roster. Doolin's a special teamer. Hilton's 40. They don't have NFL wide receivers. I mean, you look at – there were 8 receivers in the Arizona-Dallas game yesterday who would all start for the Colts.
Yeah, I'm not ready to go that route, but I know your point. You know what I mean? I know your point. I do. I know your point is they're not good enough, and other teams have a number of wide receivers that are good enough to play. I don't disagree. Appreciate you. Thank you. No, I get that. And we've said that all along. We're going to take calls all day today. We really are. I want to hear from you. We really haven't taken a lot of calls over the course of time here. So if you're on YouTube, I'll read some of your stuff. We need some interaction because I just don't feel like crushing them. I know people listen to this show. I know what you do. I do. I know what you do. Okay? You want me to crush. And I will. I can tell as the day's going on, particularly when I just read Brian Haas saying Ben Bannegoo was drafted ahead of A.J. Brown. I'm going to get pissed. I'm going to get pissed. I am. I'm going to get hot. I don't want to get hot today. Chris, what do you got?
Hey, what's going on, Coach?
Nothing, buddy.
Just wanted to see you were at the game. I watched it on TV, talked to several people that kind of agreed with. When the game started, the flow of the game, it just seemed really flat. There was no – I don't want to atmosphere. It was almost like it was a trap game. Like, we expected to go in there and win. The defense didn't have any intensity. The offense didn't have a sense of urgency. It just looked like I was watching a Pacers game.
You know, it's interesting, and that's one of the things. I thought the crowd wanted to. I thought the Raiders took it out, but I'm going to agree with you, actually, and disagree with myself from earlier. I agree with that. I do. And you know what? T.Y. Hilton said it, right? T.Y. Hilton said, hey, we didn't come to play. He said, we didn't come to play. And T.Y. Hilton blocked me a long time ago, but, you know, that's the way it goes. So I can't read what he's saying on Twitter, but the truth of the matter is, they did not come to play. I think, you know, let's be honest. The crowd, I think, and myself included in it, I felt like the Colts, okay, we're just better. We're just really good. But they weren't, and you had a team that, frankly, came in here and, I don't know the right word, but they beat their ass. I mean, it's hard to say they beat their ass, but you know what I'm talking about.
They were backed into the corner.
All game.
I mean... Yeah.
Appreciate you. I'm not jumping ship. I'm staying with my Super Bowl bet. Although I must say, going over, man, I-74 to Cincinnati doesn't look like much fun right now. Hey, I understand we all love, I do. I understand we love Jonathan Taylor. I love the dude. But if you're going to take out Brady and you're going to take out Rodgers, and you're going to put somebody in there for MVP, I'm not so sure Joey, Big Nuts Joey, isn't the guy. Big Nuts Joey yesterday, all he did in a most heavily anticipated matchup, really the biggest game, I'm not going to say of the year because it feels like we always do that. All Big Nuts Joey did was go 30 of 39. Now, I said this earlier on the early show. I'm no math major, so I know 30 for 40 is 75%. 30 for 39 is better than that. That's 79%, whatever. No interceptions, 4 touchdowns. I got to tell you, and I know that they got in a hole, and usually what happens in that hole with Kansas City is Kansas City buries you. All right, let's go back to the Colts. Top, we'll go from the top, Eddie. Let's go, Jimmy. What do you got?
Hello?
Hey, Jimmy.
No, it's George, Dan.
Hey, George, how are you? That's all right. How are you doing, my friend? George Monahan. Happy New Year to you.
Happy New Year to you.
Yeah.
Yeah, the Colts clearly were flat. I mean, they didn't come out to play yesterday, but there was a few teams like that. Kansas City lost. You know, we didn't see that coming. Baltimore lost again. They're struggling, right? Tampa Bay was taken to the mat and almost lost against the lower Jets.
Yeah.
So when the dust settled, my final conclusion was, well, at least it wasn't a playoff game where they played flat. Maybe they wake up from this one and they get back into a little bit of a run.
Here's what I think. I think one of the things that happens, George, and tell me if you agree with this, you got to get a little bit lucky in schedule, and playing right now Jacksonville to go to the playoffs, as bad as they started the season, you'll take that any time, correct?
It's what they need.
Yeah.
You know, it can be not a high-pressure game to win and get in and maybe have a chance to rest some people as that game goes on and then get ready to go for a run in the playoffs.
Yeah, appreciate it, George. Happy New Year to you, my friend, and thanks for all your support. Eddie White's calling me right now. I think that's probably by mistake. All right, let's go real quick. What do you got, John?
Happy New Year, Dan.
Same to you, John. Thanks. Thanks for saying that.
Hey, you know how we're having a little trouble with receivers, as the previous call said.
Yes.
What happened to, you know, Coach Love and the tight ends? We got Doyle. We got Mo Alie-Cox. I mean, my goodness.
I agree. I don't think Doyle caught a ball. Mo Alie-Cox caught one, maybe two. I'm with you on that. What about Granson? Granson was a guy that we thought was coming. He had played pretty good, and he was non-existent. I'm with you, man. Hey, look, I'm totally with you. I am, what's the right word?
Those guys are playmakers. Doyle and Mo, they're playmakers.
I think one of the things that needs to happen, truthfully, and I think you saw it yesterday, you need some more playmakers. You really do. You need some more playmakers, and I want Paris Campbell back, but I'm not convinced he'll last any more than 5 minutes. And, John, if you're not going to throw the ball to the tight end, you're going to have a problem. That's just what I think. I think you're going to have a serious problem. Appreciate you. Thank you. Tim, what do you got?
Hello, sir. Thank you for taking my call. Happy New Year to you.
Happy New Year to you, too. Thanks.
Thank you. Two things. Want to know how your golf game was down in Naples?
I shot 107 for a 10-year high at a course called Old Corkscrew, and which is a very tough course. It kicked my ass. I came back and shot a 38 on a very easy course with Lee and her son.
That's the keep to coming back.
And got, by the way, but the 37 was not legit because we jacked around. I'm not going to lie. We just jacked around.
Winter golf. It's all good.
Yeah.
Hey, question about IU. I give Woodson a pass because he's dealing with Archie Miller's players this year. But is the bench that bad at IU that he can't replace the three transfers when they don't play?
First off, I don't give anybody a pass at IU. IU should. I didn't even give me a pass. I'm still mad at me. So seriously, I think that. How do I put this? I'm disappointed in that in Woody. You have to be, and I want to talk about this a little bit later, Tim, but you got to be, after talking to Roy Williams and a bunch of different coaches, you got to be so careful with fifth-year guys. You got to be so careful with transfers. You got to be so careful with guys like Xavier Johnson and Stewart and these guys because, first off, you don't know if they're good enough. Second off, there's a reason they're transferring. Now, in Stewart's case, the reason was tragedy, his dad. But that guy Johnson, he transferred in the middle of a season when he was one of the best players on his team. In fact, he transferred towards the end. And I've said this forever. Be careful. And talking to Roy Williams, and it's not the character, it's just the fit. It's a fit on a team, and I'm telling you, Woody will learn that, but I don't give Woody a pass at all. You got to win that game yesterday. If you're trying to get this thing going, you got a first-year coach over there at Penn State. Their best player is some dude named John Hara, for crying out loud. What the hell is a John Hara? You know what I mean? Come on.
He had like 3,000 fans there.
He had nobody there, literally. Nobody. It was you and me and a dog named Boo. I mean, that's it, Tim. No, I'm not giving any passes. Appreciate you, my friend. Thank you. Holy cow. All right, last one, then we'll take a break. We're going to take calls all day. Fish is next, Salisbury. But other than that, I'm on with you guys. I want to talk to you all. Let's go, Bob. What say you?
Coach, four words, punched in the face.
Yeah, I knew you were going to say that. I knew that was going. Hey, what'd you think? You're an old lineman. You're a stud. You're a Big Ten player. What'd you think of the line play yesterday? Both sides.
I just really think that, it wasn't very good. I mean, Taylor had 108 yards, but it was a quiet 108 yards. I mean, it was quiet. And, I thought the Raiders played with a sense of urgency, man. I told my buddy yesterday, we was talking and texting, and I said, guys, this is a trap game. The Raiders are playing to play in the playoffs, too. I mean, they can get in the playoffs if they win out.
I know.
I mean, the line play in,
All right, what'd you think of the play overall? Trap game means what to you? A guy that played at Michigan State.
Trap game means this. It looks like to me that they I think they just thought that they were already, they mailed it in and thought I'm in the playoffs. They thought, I think the Patriots, I was in the Patriots game, great energy. They were fired up. They had something to prove. Then they go to Arizona, which a lot of people thought was going to be a game they'd lose. Mm-hmm. With what? Missing eight guys? I mean, and they win the game. I just think that it was the trap game because after two big wins, that third game right there, I just don't think their mindset was right.
I agree, and it doesn't take much. This is what I try to tell people.
No.
It's just a little bit internal where you're not – proving something's a big deal in sports. You know what I mean?
Yes, sir. And here's the thing, too, Coach. I will say this. And Reich's a good coach. I'm not going to say he's not. Frank Reich's not a good – he's a good coach. Good play caller. Wentz missed some guys open yesterday. Yeah. People did not see that. The play calls weren't bad. He missed a couple wide-open throws, and you got to make those. He's still the guy. If he plays well, they'll have a chance. If he doesn't play well, they won't get to the Super Bowl.
I agree. I mean, no, they won't. If he doesn't play well, I think they'll lose.
Said Joey Big Nuts will beat him. That guy right there is on fire right now.
How good has he been?
Hey, 525 last week for four touchdowns, and then he comes back the following week against Kansas City. And Kansas City's defense has been playing really well. I mean, they just put it on. You've been holding people to, what, mid-17, 15, 16, 17 points a game, and that guy comes in his second year and throws for 450 yards.
I'm telling you, man.
He's a baller, man. He's a player, but I really think here's the thing. I think the coaches, and the NFL's a different monster as far as getting guys fired up, but you still got to get them fired up to play. You know what I'm saying? Emphasize the importance through the week of how important that game is.
Well, I'm anxious to see because, Bobby, I got to run, but thank you. Sure. I'm anxious to see what happens to that vein in Hard Knocks. Now, you got to understand, Hard Knocks isn't all-encompassing. Don't get me wrong. But I am anxious to watch Hard Knocks and see if there was any difference. I am. All right, we'll come back. I hope Fish is joining us. He usually does. Sean Salisbury. It's Eddie Garrison in for Jimmy because Jimmy is celebrating his birthday on a beautiful, cold, but beautiful national championship week starts today here on the Dan Dockett Show. Stay right here.
From the Power Home Solar Radio Studio, here's Matt Taylor, the voice of the Colts, with today's midday update on 93.5 and 107.5 The Fan.
Good afternoon. This is the Midday Update brought to you by Shelby Materials, the concrete and aggregate experts. The Colts dropped a chance to punch their ticket to the playoffs on Sunday as they fell to the Raiders 23-20. The Colts dropped back to 9-7 on the season, but a win next Sunday in Jacksonville still guarantees them a playoff spot as a wild card team. Hopes of winning the AFC South went out the window on Sunday as the Titans clinched the division for the second straight year. The Raiders, who came into the game desperate for a win to keep their playoff hopes alive, they started fast. They scored a touchdown on their first drive of the game and blitzed out to an early 10-0 lead. They would lead 13-3 as well before a touchdown by Jonathan Taylor closed the game to 13-10 at halftime. The Colts scored a touchdown on their first drive of the third quarter as well and took the lead 17-13. The touchdown came on a deep shot by Carson Wentz that was tipped by a pair of Raiders defenders. At the goal line, the ball was deflected into the air and right to T.Y. Hilton standing in the end zone for a 45-yard score. The Colts had multiple chances to go up two scores in the second half, but the Raiders' defense held the Colts in check. Las Vegas took the lead 20-17 on an 11-yard Derek Carr touchdown pass with just over 11 minutes to go in the game. The Colts would then go on a 9-minute and 22-second drive that stalled out at the Las Vegas 22-yard line. Michael Badgley made a 41-yard field goal with just under 2 minutes to play to tie the game at 20, but the Colts would never get the ball back as the Raiders milked the clock, forced the Colts to use timeouts, and kicked a walk-off field goal as time expired for the win. Despite the loss, the Colts had more sacks, they won the turnover battle 2-0, had more rushing yards, and fewer penalties than the Raiders. Jonathan Taylor rushed for 108 yards and set the Colts' single-season rushing record. He passed Edgerrin James' season total in 2000 for that feat. Taylor also found the end zone in the first half and is now tied with Lenny Moore for the most total touchdowns in a single season in franchise history, and he can break that mark with a score next Sunday against the Jaguars. Taylor also became the youngest player in NFL history with 2,000-plus scrimmage yards and 20-plus touchdowns from scrimmage in a single season, and to top it off, he tied Edgerrin James for the most 100-yard rushing games in a single season in franchise history with 10, and he can break that record next Sunday as well in Week 18. So the Colts will go back to work this week looking to correct mistakes, and they'll be looking for their first road win over the Jaguars since 2014 in the regular season finale. And that's it for the Colts Midday Update today here on 93.5 and 107.5 The Fan, brought to you by Shelby Materials.
All right, you have the perfect contractor for your project. Now it's time to get your concrete company. Have they called Shelby Materials? We stand behind our work and products. Why? Because it's the right thing to do. We only do quality concrete and aggregates. And we work with an experienced staff that cares. Need a stadium, parking lot, highway, or driveway? Remember, when you're ready to pour, Shelby has your back. We know concrete and aggregates. Learn what you need to know, ShelbyMaterials.com.
Sports Center updates on the Fan are brought to you by Big O Tires. Stop by your locally owned and operated Big O Tires for the lowest price on every tire every day with financing options available. Big O Tires, the team you trust.
Join Mark Patrick Seminars and lose the weight guaranteed. Only $49.99. Hypnosis to destroy unwanted cravings. Also, stop smoking with Mark Patrick. Lose your desire to smoke without cravings, irritability, weight gain, or your money back. Seminars Thursday, January 20th at Holiday Inn in Carmel. Weight loss seminar 5:30 to 7:30 p.m. Stop smoking seminar 8 to 10 p.m. And Saturday, January 22nd at La Quinta Inn and Suites in Indianapolis. Weight loss seminar 11 a.m. to 1 p.m. Stop smoking seminar 2 to 4 p.m. Registration begins 30 minutes before seminar.
Do you really want to go through another year with that awful joint pain? Well, don't do it. Resolve right now to get yourself moving again for 2022. I'm Kevin Bowen, and it is time to call our friends at QC Kinetics. Non-surgical regenerative treatments for joint pain. We're talking lasting results using natural biologics. No surgery, no pain meds, no steroids, and no downtime. This is really exciting stuff. Regenerative treatments that actually encourage your body to heal itself using highly concentrated natural biologics. Patients rave about it. For hip pain relief, knee pain, shoulder, back pain, all of those things. Don't let them keep giving you steroids. Don't let them tell you that surgery is your only option. Get a free second opinion at QC Kinetics and do it now. Imagine your life in 2022 without pain. So do us a favor. Call the local medical professionals at QC Kinetics. You will not regret it. 463-235-7160. That is 463-235-7160.
I know you've been waiting a little bit longer than normal.
Jen's manicure spot needs an extra pair of hands.
Who's at the front desk right now?
Someone who's handy with everything from nail files to spreadsheet files.
Deidre's not coming in today, but we have that whole bachelorette party.
Indeed can help her hire great people fast.
I need Indeed.
Indeed you do. Instant Match instantly connects you with quality candidates whose resumes on Indeed match your sponsored job description. Visit Indeed.com/credit and get $75 towards your first sponsored job. Terms and conditions apply.
Oh, 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 O'Reilly.
Are your wiper blades chattering, skipping, or squeaking? Don't let streaks or smearing on your windshield compromise your visibility. When it's time to replace your wiper blades, stop by O'Reilly Auto Parts and see our selection. Our professional parts people will even install your new wiper blades while you wait. Stop by O'Reilly Auto Parts today.
Oh, 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 O'Reilly Auto Parts.
With an easy refinance, our clients, on average, save over $350 a month. TheHomeLoanExpert.com.
NMLS number 1326241.
Join us on The Fan and listen to Jason Hammer on You Bet with Bet Rivers, 7 to 8 p.m. on Thursdays, where you can get all the betting advice you would ever need. It's Kevin and Querry.
A Colts search for a playoff bid is going to be put on hold until week number 18.
Two ways to look at it, I guess. One is to be invigorated by the fact that you're heading down the home stretch and you're still in the playoff hunt, but the other is, man, opportunity missed.
That is the worst game the Colts have played since week 3. Here you are 2 weeks before the start of the playoffs, but at the same time, it's also kind of a compliment to how well they have played.
Kevin and Querry.
Weekday mornings at 7.
On 93.5 and 107.5. The Fan. It's Monday. It's 12:30. It's Fish. The voice of the Hoosiers, Don Fisher, joining the Dan Dockett Show.
Hey, Fish, I'm not saying this for any reason other than basketball reasons, but I freaking hate Penn State. I'm not going to lie to you, man. And it's dark in there. Used to be that lady was always yelling. They always play down the stretch with IU. I don't like it. I don't like it at all.
Well, here's the thing, Doc. If you were in that building last night, you would have seen all of maybe 5,000 fans. It's always the most dour atmosphere in college basketball that I've dealt with, in the sense of not very many people there. The students are gone at this time of year, as you know, so that brings no excitement or energy to the building. And without question, they could have kept the old field house that they had back in the early 90s, and it would have been a rocking place, but they don't do that anymore. They built a new nice facility, and people at Penn State just don't care about basketball that much.
They don't. They really don't. I remember doing a game there, and they showed like two people sitting upstairs, and I said, hey, look, if Penn State officials should just let everybody come down, right? And they did, you know.
Well, now they don't let anybody sit up in the upper deck. I mean,
better yet.
The entire upper deck is curtained off. The entire upper deck.
Man. And,
all the way around that facility.
And so that should be the easiest place to go get a win. I mean, let's be honest. You got a first-year coach. I mean, it used to be you worried about Glenn Robinson and Jimmy Jackson. Now you're worried about John Herer. You know what I mean? It's like, come on.
No, and it was sad last night. I mean, I won't say who it was, but somebody came up to me after the game and, man, was that like deja vu? I said, yeah, if you're relating it to last year, it certainly was. And that's exactly what they were thinking, the same thing. It looked like the same team as a year ago. It just was. There was no fluidity in the offense. There was too much standing. When they couldn't get the ball into trace, it was like
pulling teeth to get anything going offensively. And honestly, the defense in that ball game last night was atrocious. I mean, Mike even talked about it in the post game, not pleased at all, especially with the 3-point guarding of the line. And obviously, they go for 11 of 22, so they shoot 50% from three. And it was ridiculous. I mean, guys wouldn't, they had guys wide open to shoot those shots. I mean, you got to put pressure on 3-point shooters, and I don't know that we had pressure on hardly any of our shots at all.
Fish, I did think they threw in some nonsense at big times, like what, 5-6 minutes ago. Guys spun around and hit a three or two. But hey, look, that's a home game. Indiana, let's stay with shooting. 4 for 17, Fish, even under 40% overall when you got a post guy shooting 18 times, which I think you should have the post guy shooting 18 times, but you're sitting there at 23%, man, from three. 4 for 17. Where are these transfers that are supposed to help this out, Fish?
Well, I mean, Parker Stewart had 4 shots last night, 2 from behind the arc. Neither one went in, and he only hit 1 shot in the ball game, so he only takes 4 shots. Miller Kopp has been as inconsistent as anybody that we've seen at Indiana in a long time. I mean, he gets on a hot streak. He can go, as he did against Syracuse, with 28. But most of the time, it's between 4 and 8 points if he's not really shooting it well. And those games, the well games, have been far and few between. So, honestly, right now they are struggling. I guess maybe the positive in all this from a player standpoint is what Finney's been doing of late. Yeah. He's had 3 straight games where he's looked much better offensively, especially shooting the basketball, and his defense always is part of the reason why Indiana's pretty good at the defensive end of the floor.
Fish, what's going on with Tamar Bates? I mean, 13 points against Nebraska, but that's been a month ago. Now, only 6 minutes. Something going on here?
Well, I don't know if Mike is just not very pleased with what guys are doing coming off the bench. Anthony Leal played some last night, but not a lot. Geronimo played. I thought he actually played pretty well when he was in there, but there's just not a lot of help coming from the bench right now. Part of that playing time, obviously, and coaches' decisions. And my only thought is that they're not doing a good job at the defensive end of the floor, not that anybody did last night. He points to the defense almost every time when he's talking about playing time, saying if you play defense, that's your quickest way to get out in the court. So I'll be interested to hear some of his comments on our talk show tonight, Doc, because I think this might be an interesting one.
Yeah, but here's the thing. I'm disappointed in Mike from this standpoint and no other standpoint. I thought he would be more a sit your ass on the bench. Like, you know what I mean? Like, maybe he doesn't trust these guys, obviously, but I thought he'd be more like, all right, we started Leal the one time, but I thought he'd be more like, hey, let's get your ass on the bench and let's go Cop or whoever. I don't know, Fish. I'm probably wrong, but I kind of thought Mike was going to do that.
And I think he has done it a couple times, but we haven't seen it all the time. And I do think, I mean, Miller Kopp is a guy that's a really smart kid, knows what he's doing out there in the basketball court, but sometimes he just doesn't have it when it comes to shooting.
Yeah.
And it's been more often negative than it has been positive so far this year. That's my concern. Stewart, I think, is a work in progress. I think he's a guy that actually plays pretty good at the defensive end of the floor in addition to what his capabilities are offensively. But he is not a guy that can create his own shot. He's a catch-and-shoot
guy,
Doc, and that's a big problem for him.
I want to get to that, Fish, because one of the things that you got to be able to do in college basketball is create. You got to get in gaps, find and kick. Fish, I swear, I'm sitting there going, you know, really only, and I think this is accurate, pretty accurate, Finney's the only guy. Do you think at some point Lander, or is Lander, I don't know, I'm surprised Lander's still there. Good for him, but you need somebody to go create something, don't you? I think you're right.
I mean, I do, and I don't. And Xavier Johnson is a guy that if he tries to do that, he doesn't do a good job of it because
decision making's tough.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
That's his problem. So I don't know. Maybe Trey Galloway can help him in those departments, Doc. I like the kid. I think he's worked himself back into playing shape, and I think he's ready to go for perhaps Thursday night against Ohio State. At least they've hinted that way here in the last few days. And Larry's told me that he's really practiced really well, so good. Maybe that'll help a little bit.
I hope so. Good. I mean, look, we all, you know, People, well, you and Fish always talk. No, we just tell you what's happening, man. We're not into, you know, we're just going to tell you. I mean, that's, you know, we're old enough that we don't care. I mean, let's go that route.
Yeah, we can only tell you what we see, yeah. What we think we see. So if you're seeing something different, whoever's criticizing can let me know.
Yeah, 317-239-1070. Come on with Dan and Fish, man. You know, but that is disappointing because, let's be honest, if you are going to compete and you got an older squad, I mean, I'm not necessarily saying these guys have played together, and Mike talks about that all the time, but nobody in college basketball has been right. Old, right? And you got some guys that are old in terms of years, and you got to win that game. I'm sorry, you just got to if you're Indiana.
Yeah, I agree. And here's the thing, Doc. Look at what Ben Johnson has done at Minnesota, and 90% of his roster is transfers.
Right.
They've lost one game. And Indiana's got three transfers, or four, actually, if you want to call Parker Stewart, because he was obviously on campus last year but didn't play. But honestly, and look at Penn State. I mean, Penn State did it with a guy transferring from Canisius, a guy from Siena,
yes.
and Western Michigan. So they had four transfers on the floor last night, none of them from big schools.
Fish, I learned this, and I didn't know this. I just thought, okay. But I'm going around talking to Chris Holtman and Roy Williams in particular, and Izzo and a bunch of guys, like, man, we all think transfers are the answer, but you better get the right one. And that includes a fifth year, because usually a fifth year, and I think you're seeing it at Michigan with this kid Jones, a fifth year has his own agenda. You know what I mean?
Right.
I mean, you just got to be careful, man. There's a reason why a lot of coaches didn't win a lot with transfers, and few do. Now, look, hey, Baylor's winning with I get it. Teams are winning, but you got to be so careful, and you got to know, man. I don't know.
You got to know if they fit. That's what it boils down to.
Yes, it does. And I'm not saying anybody fits or doesn't fit. The season's just getting started. But, Fish, that's a bad loss. That's a bad loss because Ohio State's pretty good coming in here, and that's going to be an interesting game Thursday, you know?
And so is Minnesota. Yeah. They got them Sunday.
Yeah.
So I'm not holding my breath right now about how good we're playing, because we're not. And here's the thing. I was told that practices leading up to that game were the two best practices they've had this year. So I don't know what happened last night.
Isn't that amazing? Like, I swear to God, Fish, people can say whatever they'd like, but the psychology of a good practice, a walkthrough, a bad walkthrough, hell, I don't know, man. When we lost here to Minnesota on that Hoffarver shot, I told my wife, I go, this is the first time we've been a great together team, man. Everybody's working their brains out. Shoot, we got down 16 in 5 minutes. I've quit doing that. You know what I mean? Like all my degenerates when I was broadcasting, be like, hey, you saw walkthrough. Who's going to win? I go, look, if I tell you, you're going to lose money, and then you're going to be pissed at me. So bet on whoever the hell you want, because walkthroughs don't mean nothing. I swear to God, it's crazy.
That's right.
Fish, I shot 107 at Old Corkscrew in Naples, lad, 2 weeks ago. I'm not happy with the golf game. Just tell me.
I understand that, but, Doc, I'm still jealous because I haven't played a round of golf in 3 months. So.
I know. I wanted to tell you that just for you. Happy New Year, my friend. Thanks for coming
on. Happy New Year to you too, Doc.
All right. That's a great Don Fisher on the hotline, brought to you by Flight by Yingling, the next generation of light beer. I'm not going to lie to you. My wife made me an unbelievable salad. Because Danuary is here, Sean Black. It is Danuary, and I'm losing weight. I'm not boozing. There'll be no alcohol except for Wild Card Saturday, Wild Card Weekend. That's it. No booze.
I should add one more exception in there.
Give it to me.
If the Colts make the Super Bowl, I think you should add that in there
as an
exception.
That's in February.
But you said this year, didn't you?
No. I'm sorry. This is January.
My bad.
Oh, we gotta recalibrate in February.
Okay.
The goal, I weighed in at 250.8. I want to get in the 230s at the end of January. I'm already down. I'm only weighing myself every other day. I'm already down to 247. So I'm down 3. But I tell you what, last night it would have been nice. I'm into tequila. Boy, it would have been nice to have a nice tequila. It was cold. I took the dog for a walk, came home, ended up having a diet root beer, Eddie. It's not quite the same. and I pee just as much. I don't like it, Eddie. All right, we'll be back. I got my Colts scarf on because I got one at the game. 317-239-1070. We are rolling on a Monday.
Hi, I'm Tom Allen, head coach of IU football. One of my favorite things about coaching my team is our slogan, LEO. It stands for love each other. And it's a reminder to put others first. Today, I'm asking you to join the LEO movement by sending some love to Damar Services. Damar is a critical resource for people with autism and other developmental disabilities, and your support helps them reach even more children. Learn more or donate today at damar.org/LEO.
Hey, it's JMV at Race Trash Service. They're all about protecting the environment while bringing cost savings to you. Natural resources are going up in price, and landfill space is disappearing. So Race is committed to preserving the Hoosier environment and serving Central Indiana with efficient, cost-effective, and responsible waste removal and recycling solutions. They're one of the largest recyclers in the state of Indiana with customer rebates on paper, cardboard, and so much more. Visit racetrash.com to see how they can bring recycling solutions to your organization.
All right, we've hit the final week of the pro football regular season, and college football is headed to the championship right here. DraftKings Sportsbook has an unbelievable offer to get all fans in on the action. Excuse me, for this, oh boy, incredibly exciting time of the year. New customers bet $5 on any football team to win their game. If they do, you get $200 in free bets. So let's wind down the season with a monster win. DraftKings Sportsbook customers also bet on football with same-game parlays. Combine multiple bets for a same game, you get a bigger payout. More legs, more money. Simple. Download the top-rated DraftKings Sportsbook app right now. Use promo code 1075FAN. Bet just $5 on any football team, college or pro, and win $200 in free bets if they're victorious. That's promo code 1075FAN this week only at DraftKings Sportsbook. You got to be 21 or older. Indiana only, new customers only. Restrictions apply. See DraftKings.com/sportsbook for details. Gambling problem? 1-800-9-WITH-IT.
With a free offer from Jiffy Lube and Pennzoil, here's owner Steve Center.
As we approach another Indiana winter, your neighborhood Jiffy Lube shops are offering free winter safety checks. No appointment and no purchase is necessary. Just stop into any Jiffy Lube and we will check your tires, brakes, battery, wiper blades, fluid levels, and answer any questions you may have about dashboard lights or any strange noises your car may be making. It's all part of Jiffy Lube's focus on becoming your trusted source for preventive maintenance. Cars and trucks are made so well these days that all you need to do is take care of them and they will last a long time. 200,000 miles is the new 100,000 miles. So stop into Jiffy Lube today. No appointment and no purchase necessary. And let our trained technicians do a free winter safety check to give you the confidence to make it through another Indiana winter.
Jiffy Lube, Indiana's favorite oil change since 1985, proudly features Pennzoil. It's not just oil, it's Pennzoil.
Hi, I'm Ryan Kelly with thehomeloanexpert.com. There's never been a better time for a cash-out refinance. TheHomeLoanExpert.com.
NMLS number 1326-241.
The Pacers head to New York to face the Knicks tomorrow night at 7 on 93.5 and 107.5 The Fan. The Dan Dockett Show on 93.5 and 107.5, The Fan.
No, that was not Sooner Ross, a cheeseburger. That, my friend, was a salad. I'm holding it up for the YouTube crowd right here. Yeah. Reggie Jones.
What's up, Daniel? How you doing today, sir?
Good. I told you, you had to give me more than one white wide receiver that kills the Colts, and you did. You gave them to me. Let's go. What do you got?
Okay, well, Cooper Kupp, who's my favorite, started the season off by killing us.
Yeah.
Then we went to Baltimore, and Matt, I can't think of his last name.
Mark Andrews. Andrews.
Andrews just torched us. Of course, Gronk is going to torch us. And then we had Renfro yesterday. Now, I went and I did some research on Renfro.
Yep.
And Renfro looks like the a manager who just didn't have enough players to take a team photo, and you said, "Hey, grab a uniform and let's go."
Yeah.
I mean,
yeah.
He doesn't look like a football player.
No.
He just made plays. I mean, so hey, there you have it, right there.
Hunter, it was a bad night for Kenny Moore and the rest. I know we love Kenny Moore. I get it. And we looked up a picture. I was with my wife, my stepdaughter, and her friend, Danny Duchelle. And on the way back, we were looking up pictures of Hunter Renfrow. Yeah. And other than the receding hairline, he literally looked like the guy who just hangs around the team. That's it.
First of all, his name is Hunter. Okay, let's get that.
Right, that's enough. Yes.
That right there. So we got torched by Hunter and Cooper.
Oh, that's even worse.
Hunter and Cooper.
That makes it worse.
Yeah, it does, man. I mean, you know, when the guys get together, they got to talk about that.
They do, and I don't mind getting torched by Gronk.
No, I mean, you expect that.
Right.
You expect that from Gronk.
But Hunter?
Hunter, can that be the guinea
pig? I can add another one in there.
Who? We got another one.
Hunter Henry.
We got another one?
Hunter Henry hurt the Colts?
Yeah, the tight end for New England.
Oh, yeah, he hurt the Colts, yeah.
Oh, forgot about him. You know, I just think that if we play anybody who has white guys as a receiver, we're going to lose.
I think it's...
Saying,
you can say that. I can't say that.
Well, you can't say a lot of things that I can say. I mean, just like this whole thing about you not being able to find a job. I know.
My wife said the other day, 104 games on TV, and you ain't good enough to do one of them? Damn.
Wait a minute. Let's back up. There were 12,552 football games. There are sideline reporters that you could do something on the sideline. They didn't hire you. There's 127,000 basketball games. They had jump rope on TV. You can't even get a job to do jump rope. Do we need to, like, set up a GoFundMe, get a job for Dan?
Tell the world what you actually said to me. Tell the world what I should do to get a job. Please, do it.
I'm just saying, man. I just think that we're living in 2022.
Yeah.
Everybody's free. I was thinking maybe a gender change or a racial change. You know?
Racial change.
Maybe change it up a little bit. I'm, you know.
Which one could you help me more with?
Probably the gender.
All right. Okay.
No, the racial thing, because you're Serbian, you're halfway there.
Yeah, I got some olive skin. Yeah.
Yeah, you got some olive skin. Yeah. You hang out in Gary a lot.
Yep. I mean, yeah.
You relate to the brothers very well.
I know.
To most of them, until you get on their nerves.
Then they get pissed off. Yeah. No, that's the same thing with white guys. There's no difference. You know, the same thing there.
You work both ends of the spectrum. But, you know, we got to figure out how to get you on TV, man, because I was watching the game yesterday, and I'm going to just tell you, I almost turned the volume down because it was, man. What's the guy's announcer, the football player? He was horrible.
What game was he watching? Vilma. Jonathan Vilma.
Jonathan Vilma.
Yeah.
I hate to trash him, but, man, he's not good, man.
I was surprised. That was a big game, at least to us. And when you're bad, you get Vilma. You know,
I mean, that's not cool, man. I mean, he was talking about food and not liking stuff and calling people swines for eating pork.
Yeah.
I'm like, hold up, man. Calm down. I mean, can we get back to the football game? We were already playing not well enough to keep my attention, but I didn't need a commentator who was taking me out of it, too. So,
no, I'm with you. I'm with you.
think about that. I mean, as you go into your whole January losing weight, think about how we might need to get you back on the air, man, because I can't take it.
Well, I'm not, you know, I don't think I can do anything about gender or race. I just don't. I'd like to. You know, I would love to, but I don't think I can do anything about it.
Maybe when you fill out an application, you put on there that you're a different race or gender.
Friend of mine did that to get into law school. He got in. This is in the 80s. I mean, he put a different heritage just because of what his last name sounded like. And he got in law school. Yeah. It's all good. It's all good.
I mean, hey, I got Funky giving us ideas, too. He's texting me. But, you know, he just wanted to get a shameless plug in.
Yeah.
He doesn't want to help out any other way. I tried to get him to go in with, like, the bike program with me.
Yeah.
And he was like, Doc, he doesn't need any more money.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
I mean, come on, Funk.
Funky is to say the word cheap is such an underestimate. No, and now he's a partner owning this company, and he's still cheap as hell. He sucks.
Is that what I hear when I hear him on the phone? I hear that squeaking noise. Him squeaking. He's so
yes,
cheap.
Yes.
Okay,
you do.
Okay.
Reggie, right. You've made your point. The white wide right. receiver is kicking our ass.
Yep, between that and then you figuring out how to get back on TV, let me know, man. We got to put our heads together.
Get off my lawn. Hey, Happy New Year. Happy New Year. See ya.
Thank you.
See ya. Yeah, he said one, and I thought, you can't give me one. Eddie, you got any more? What'd you say, Hunter Henry?
Hunter Henry, yeah.
Yeah, too many Hunters kicking the Colts' ass. Maybe that's what it is. Hunters and Coopers. I don't like it. We need Eddies and Dans.
I like the sound of that.
Frank, Eddie, Dan, Sal. Where's old Sal?
Jimmy.
Yeah. Thomas. I'll take a Thomas kicking your ass. Hi, Cooper. Come kick our ass. I don't like it. No. It's a curse of Hunter Smith, they say. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Dan, did you know that Carr was in the backfield eating caviar? Yeah, I don't know. Did Deo play yesterday? Did he? Did he do anything?
I don't remember. I know he was in there on that first sack, but that was about it.
Yeah, and I know that the other guy, Quiddy Pay, was on the first sack or one of the sacks. Yeah. Hey, Dan, you know gender can be changed. Yeah, I'm not going to do that. Not there's anything wrong with it. Everything's good. All right, Sean Salisbury next. Buckle up, people. He got a lot to say. We'll be right back.
It's Kevin and Querry.
The Colts search for a playoff bid is going to be put on hold until week number 18.
Two ways to look at it, I guess. One is to be invigorated by the fact that you're heading down the home stretch and you're still in the playoff hunt, but the other is, man, opportunity missed.
That is the worst game the Colts have played since week 3. Here you are 2 weeks before the start of the playoffs, but at the same time, it's also kind of a compliment to how well they have played.
Kevin and Querry.
Weekday mornings at 7.
On 93.5 and 107.5. The Fan.
All right, Dan Dockage here, Daniel J. Dockage. For my friends at the Michelis Corporation, it's a new year. Get some stuff done to your house, okay? If you've got any kind of water problems caused by all the rain that we've had, here's a number, 844-FIX-INDY. Trust me on this. 844-FIX-INDY or online at MichelisCorp.com. Michelis is spelled like Michael is. Now, if you think your roof was damaged this summer, I'm telling you, time is going fast. Sometimes you only have 1 year to get it fixed, and we're already halfway through. Because normally, these storms happen back in August and July. You got to get that thing fixed. Have Michelis come out and give you a free estimate and a free evaluation. And, of course, wind damage. We got a lot of wind, too. We got a lot of trees around here. Next thing you know, one falls, or you got a problem with one, Michelis will help you out. With that, fire, water, wind damage, you name it, Michelis will help you at 844-FIX-INDY. Of course, you can go online at MichelisCorp.com. Lee and I have used them for a number of things, and we absolutely love the people working at Michelis.
Hi, I'm Emmitt Smith, Pro Football Hall of Famer and 3-time champion.
Pro Football's all-time leading rusher Emmitt Smith talks about joint pain.
Trust me, I know about joint pain. Sure, I made it look easy, but if my body could speak, it would say, I'm in pain.
Are you living with chronic joint pain? Knees, hips, lower back, shoulders? Don't just assume the old treatments are the only treatments.
I've gone under the knife to get rid of pain, but now there are options, and you need to check them out.
Emmett's talking about QC Kinetics, exciting new natural biologic therapies that can repair and restore damaged tissue in your joints. New options, now available here.
You can encourage your body to actually heal itself with the help of QC Kinetics.
Real relief with no surgery, no drugs, no downtime. Call the local medical professionals at QC Kinetics for regenerative restorative treatments with lasting relief.
But now, you and I, we have help. QC Kinetics.
Call QC Kinetics, 463-235-7160. That's 463-235-7160. QC Kinetics, 235-7160.
Today on Hey Culligan's Smart Home Smarter Water Softener, here's Kevin.
Hey Culligan, can a smart water softener lift those heavy salt bags for me?
Kevin, it can.
Wait, it can?
Yep, the smart high-efficiency water softener from Culligan can alert your dealer when the salt needs to be replaced, and they'll do it for you, so your water stays soft and you stay away from lifting the bags.
I mean, I could lift them if I wanted.
No judgment here, Kevin. We're happy to do it, and we're already on the way. Let us help you out with a free in-home water test with the local Culligan water expert at Culligan.com.
You could save big when you bundle your home and auto with Progressive, but when we just come out and say it, it feels like it falls a bit flat. So we're going to tap into human emotion, first with some music. Then in a serious tone, I'll say, save big when you bundle your home and auto with Progressive. And even though it was about saving money with Progressive, we'll fade out the music so you know it was poignant. Wow, powerful stuff. Progressive Casualty Insurance Company and Affiliates. Discount not available in all states or situations.
Sports Center updates on the Fan are brought to you by Big O Tires. Stop by your locally owned and operated Big O Tires for the lowest price on every tire every day with financing options available. Big O Tires, the team you trust.
93.5 and 107.5, The Fan.
WIBC HD2 W298BB. WIBC HD3 W228CX, Indianapolis.
The Colts close out the regular season against the Jaguars in Jacksonville. Coverage Sunday morning at 10 on 93.5 and 107.5 The Fan. It's the Dan Dockett Show, 93.5 and 107.5, The Fan.
Yeah, you know, I don't know if Reggie Jones, the curse of the white wide receiver on the Colts. Yeah, I don't know. Sean Salisbury might. I got a caller says it's the curse of the white wide receiver against the Colts. I told him we'll do a segment if you can name like four. He named four, and then Eddie, my producer, aimed another one. Renfro, Hunter Renfro kicked the Colts' ass. That guy's pretty good, Coach.
Yeah, he's really good. We've got a lot of good receivers in this league, and I'm not sure skin color has anything to do with
it. I don't either, but it was pretty funny.
Hilarious. That's hilarious. Yeah. And then we got that kid from Utah that everybody was talking about. Well, that's a Belichick draft pick, that Covey kid, mm-hmm. who's returning kicks and running all over. So he's the next one that's going to dominate somebody. But, Dan, we got some pretty good players at the position. And Renfro, you remember, it seemed like he was in college for like 47
yes.
years. But he perfected, I mean, he had like that, you know, like the receding hair. He looked like he'd been in the league like 18 years by the time he left college. But he is a, Dan, in this league, honest to God, no matter if you're like Devontae Adams, who's a precise route runner and closer and finisher, or if you're Cooper Kupp, or if you're Renfro, or the guys, talent's one thing too, but it's an amazing thing. And I've been with guys who may lack a little of the home run speed somebody else has, or may not be 6'5", but it doesn't matter if you're an X, a Y, or a Z, or an H-back, any of those guys that are running around, that if you understand route combinations and understand when to sit down and when to run away, Steve Largent was the best at. Now, I know he's a Hall of Famer, but another guy that they kid about a white wide receiver, but he was so precise in his route running that it didn't really matter that he was a 4.59, 4.6 guy. So, yeah, I think that's a funny topic to have. But the truth is, the Cooper Kupps and Renfros are really good players, just like the Devontae Adams and the Justin Jeffersons are too. But anybody who can get open, quarterbacks trust guys who can finish. And Renfro was great yesterday, and we see it all over the league with great route runners. That makes up for a lot of measurables that some guys may not have.
You know, it's funny. I feel, and this is stupid, I got to feel this way, but Reggie Jones, who's my friend, is African American. So I told him on the air, you can say that. I can't say that.
Oh, yeah, yeah. But no, everybody knows. It's like when we always say, well, you know what? Bill Belichick will just get another white slot receiver,
right,
and put him, you know, doing all that. So everybody knows the joke, and it's fun. And I don't think anybody takes it serious, because when you watch a guy like Cooper Kupp or Renfro play, they're just great players, right? I mean, we've gotten to the point where it doesn't matter if you can run routes and finish. you can run them. And the Colts, and I think that's a great line by Reggie, so I love it.
Yeah.
I think it's classic. But bottom line is guys get open and finish, and it just happened to be Renfro yesterday, and they've seen that movie before.
Let me go this route with you, because I like him. I'm not really that enthralled with him. I'm at the game yesterday, and I got to tell you, I am now a fan of Derek Carr. That dude controls everything on that team. And we're talking about Renfro, then he's got that other guy, was it Zay Jones? I mean, he doesn't have these, Waller's out, I thought he was terrific yesterday, and he's always good late, is he not?
Yeah, and remember, very good closer.
Yeah.
And Henry Ruggs, too,
who's
not there, and he's had to overcome that loss with what happened in that situation. Here's how I feel as a lifelong diehard Raider fan, Dan, and I grew up as a Raider, John Madden, God rest his soul, mm-hmm. and the Raiders were the reason, and my dad, that I chose to play football, because I grew up watching those incredible Steelers-Raiders rivalries in the 70s. Well, with Carr, I don't think he gets the credit he deserves. I don't. He's always accurate. And I had one coach tell me, and I leave his name out because I the respect. He said, "Listen, he is as hard a worker as you'll ever be around. He's competitive as hell. He's bright." He said, "Just keep an eye on him outdoors. If he gets hit early, late, like in Kansas City in December or in someplace in January." Now he didn't mean it derogatory. He said that if there was ever a question mark, it's if you hit him early in a game, how does he respond? Now, I think that we've seen answers to that, and it wasn't a regular thing, but if there was going to be a fault in his game, it was that. And he's extremely competitive. I don't know if the Raiders are going to move on from him, which we've heard rumors. Where are you going?
That's right. Just it.
Who are you going to replace him with? Because he's always pushing in that 65 to 70% completion percentage. He, quite frankly, is the heart and soul of the football team because of the pressure he's got. If he doesn't play well, they've got zero shot. And so, and that's the case with a lot of quarterbacks, but some can overcome that at times if their quarterback doesn't play well. But I think he's understated. I think he's underrated. I think he's highly competitive, and I think he's extremely well-respected around the league. And I think the Raiders right now, and I go up and down on it because I think, okay, has he hit a ceiling? And then you say, well, put great players around him and let's see what happens, because he does it. He's never had offense, defense, special teams all great at the same time. Well, then the question is, well, can he elevate him? I think he's done his job to elevate. And if they lose in the playoffs, if they win next week and are able to get in, Dan, and take care of their business, they're right. They got to win next week, I think, to get in. Am I correct?
Yeah.
Just like you guys got to. They got to beat the Chargers, and you guys got the Jacksonville next week, if I'm not mistaken. So the question is, where are you going to replace him if you do? And I think for the next level of him, and he was having that MVP season when he got hurt and Connor Cook took over against and lost that playoff game against the Texans. So I think the next level is for Derek Carr to bust through one of those playoff games and do it on the road where everybody says, oh, okay. But he really has been quite spectacular for them at times. And I know when they lose, it always points to him. But without him, I'm not sure the Raiders are even sniffing the playoffs right now.
I think you got to be careful what you wish for when it comes to quarterback.
Agreed.
Don't you?
100%. We're in such a knee-jerk thing. Guy can have two bad games, want to get rid of him. Guy can have five great games, and we're ready to crown him a Hall of Famer. But the one thing I know that Derek Carr has done, he has withstood the test of time and continued to be competitive. I think he's a really, really good football player, and his accuracy is hard to find. And he's one of those guys in the league that's always going to give you a chance.
Yeah. I mean, look, I watch him. You know how it is. Sometimes you get in a – and the environment was good. I think Indiana, I think the whole place here yesterday, it was a trap game for fans and everyone else because the Colts had played well. We're all in love with the Colts as players because we've watched Hard Knocks. You know what I mean? I mean, it's one of those deals. And he just controlled it from the get-go. They came out. They ran the football. Josh Jacobs seemed like he was back. And then, you know what? He made the play down the field, and Renfro helped him. I don't know.
On a 3rd and 10 play, to get a completion, an accurate throw, Renfro after the catch.
Yes.
Now, Dan, this is really epitomized. This is where we are. And with the Raiders, and I could tell you in and out about that org. I mean, I follow them like I played for them, and I didn't. But this is exactly where people want to know. They're next week. He went on the road and beat the Colts mm-hmm. against a team that some considered the second best team or so in the AFC at the time. And he goes on the road and wins that. Now the question is, can he beat, doesn't matter whether, can he beat a good Charger team? Can he close it out, get him to the playoffs, and then, because they'll go like four in a row and lose one or two and then play average, and he may still put up good numbers. I think they want to see, I mean, I'm talking about the people who overjudge him or judge him unfairly, want to say, okay, show me what you got now. Do it back-to-back.
Mm-hmm.
Show me what you got. But you continue to look at his numbers. Every single year, I think, as a Raider, he's thrown for 4,000-plus yards. Every single year. I mean, since when John Gruden took every one of Gruden's since Gruden was there and now that he's gone, but when he's been the head coach, I mean, it's like it clockwork, 4,000, 4,000, 4,000. I mean, he puts up numbers, and he's accurate, and this guy is a really good football player. And you mentioned at the line of scrimmage and controlling everything and leading and making throws late and keeping you in games and throwing. He did it a couple weeks ago. He threw him back into a game, or was it last week other than this game, and put him in position to kick a field goal. Might have been last week. So Derek Carr's a good player. And as much as his brother, who was the first pick of the draft, got knocked around in Houston with all those sacks, Derek Carr overall is a better player than him. I mean, it's poor out in his career. But had we done this all over again and Derek Carr – We redrafted. There's no doubt he would have been a first round pick, but that's a long time ago. But he is bearing out why that people think he can be a franchise quarterback. I'm anxious to see how he responds next week. Can he go back to back and do this and get them in the playoffs, and then see what happens in a wild card game in January? That's how he gets judged, and we'll find out if he can extend this to give him a chance for people to really give him more credit than he's gotten, to be honest with you. A
couple of people asked me, does he wear eyeliner? What's up with his eyes?
I don't know. I don't know. I have no idea. And I understand. I don't think so. I'm not real good. I'm not real good at the understanding of the cosmetic look when it comes to that.
Wait a second. Hold on. You've dated starlets. You're a movie star yourself. Stop it. Don't BS me, pal. Don't try to be like us.
This is just waking up, and you look in the mirror and say, "It's like Fonzie." Hey, what do I got to do? No, I don't know. Maybe it's just the dark hair and the look and the rugged hand. I don't have any idea, but I don't care what he does. If he keeps throwing balls like that and completes balls next week and gets them in the playoffs, he can throw it. He can throw it around his back. Where I don't care what he wears. He can wear blush, too, as long as he's throwing completions and getting the Raiders in position to win.
True story. When I was at Bowling Green, we played Marshall, and the coach at Marshall, when it was a TV game, used to wear makeup.
There's one coach, I'll leave his name out, that wanted, normally it would have been the visitor sideline, a college coach, but he made sure, because the cameras faced that sideline, so they made sure that was the university sideline was where the cameras were going straight in on him. God. So, those egos and a little narcissism does exist. I can guarantee you that. I don't know about Derek Carr if he cares about that.
Yeah, I don't know.
There are people that do out there. And hey, if you want the cameras on, want makeup, and it leads to more money because you look better, God bless you.
Yeah, no kidding.
Do.
I mean, it
doesn't help me, so I wouldn't. I wouldn't know the difference. So the only time I've ever put makeup on is when I would go on TV, and you know all about that, Dan, by doing it. So if I have to do that, fine. But it didn't exactly enhance my knowledge. So there you go.
My favorite person, Lakeisha, she's the makeup lady. When I first started in TV at the Big Ten Network, I sat down and she looked and she goes, "Really? What do you want me to do here?" I go, I don't know. I don't know.
I say the same thing, Dad. I used to at ESPN, I'd say, "Well, make me look like $1 million," and they'd look at me like, I'm not a magician, Sean, okay?
Yeah.
So there you have it. You and I ran into the same thing, a couple of dudes trying to get it done. Finally, I just said, hey, put a little powder on so there's no shine and get me out of here because it ain't going to help me anyway. So
that's exactly
they were awesome. Yeah,
that's exactly. Hey, Joe Burrow, as good as it gets, huh? 1,000 yards over the last two games against two pretty damn good teams.
Yeah, I think the only player in history, Dan, the quarterback, to go 400, four TDs and no picks in back-to-back games.
Wow.
I don't think anybody's ever done that. He's really good. And the thing I like most about him, I mean, we know he can throw it. We know he has – I mean, you think about the transformation from his first year at LSU when they were struggles, and then he had a good bowl game, which led him into the next year with Joe Brady, and then that you know, the greatest yardage season and touchdown season basically of all time. And then to break, you know, to tear his ACL last year while he was going good, and then to come back and rehab it and do this, he is a friggin' monster. Dan, I tweeted over the weekend, if you give me Joe Burrow and you want to take everybody else, I mean, if you stick me with Joe Burrow, I'm going to beat your ass more than you'd be fine.
Yeah.
He is. And there's this, and I'm not comparing him, Dan. I don't know if you and I discussed this last week or a couple weeks ago. I'm not comparing him to Brady, but there is a sense of, and the, you know, like the Rodgers and Brady, that feeling that they just know they got you.
Yes.
And that they're so confident, and it's not fake. A lot of us can fake confidence, but there's this deep down in their soul where they know they're going to rip your heart out. I mean, he outdueled Mahomes. We've seen him all. It doesn't matter. He loves this stuff. And you can't fake love in the competition and the heat of battle, because eventually the fake, you know, it rises out there and you can see, well, this guy's more cosmetic, as we talk, no pun intended, than substance. This dude's substance, because he's already knows, and you and I have discussed this, what his football rock bottom looked like, getting beat out at Ohio State, having to transfer, then blowing out his knee. So all that other stuff, he doesn't get caught up in all the nonsense. There is a confidence about him that you could kind of see at LSU, not kind of, you saw at LSU and it transferred over. I honestly, Dan, believe when he left and came to Cincinnati, a team that was, you know, that's scrambling around, thinking about getting rid of Zach Taylor, their head coach, and he comes in there and for years, as we know, just kind of wallowing in just a bad organization. I promise you, I believe with all my heart when he says we're going to go turn it around, and I think he knew he was going to do this. I don't know how soon. But I don't believe you can just be talented. There's something in his DNA that is, he's a different cat. Aside from the talent and his accuracy, I mean, he's again up near 70% with all these yards and all these touchdowns, and he's cut down the second half of the season on his picks last 4 or 5 weeks. So there's something about great ones, and it's not just the physical gifts or the fact that they know football. There's a little arrogance or a believability that you can't fake. It's like leadership, Dan. You can't fake that, right? Fake leadership gets found out, where you're trying to press it and force it. You either got it or you don't. And you either got this part of, I honestly think he thinks he's going to turn Cincinnati into the New England Patriots. I believe he thinks that. And it ain't a bad thing, because he's got weapons and he's doing it. He's got the same DNA that picked the 5 or 6 guys who got it in each sport, basketball, baseball, football. He's one of them. I'm just telling you, he is. And everybody that talks about him says the same thing. And then he's a closer as well. He will put you in position to win games. And Cincinnati is, you know, we haven't seen this since Boomer's teams and Sam Weiss's teams. I'm talking about on a consistent basis, a little bit with Dalton and Marvin Lewis. It's different. And this quarterback's different, because he's got an arrogance but it's not a fake one, that you have to have at that position, because I don't think he gives a rat's ass if he throws a pick. I think he always thinks he's going to get you.
You know, I always go to this, Sean. Sean Salisbury, the best, on with us Mondays, and he's so good with his time. Much appreciated. excuse me, on the hotline brought to you by Flight by Yuengling, next generation of light beer. Sean, I always look at coaches and players, and I always say to myself, okay, would I follow that guy?
Right.
I'm watching Joe Burrow after the national championship, smoking a cigar. He's my kind of guy. I'm watching him yesterday, right? And he's doing his thing. And I'm like, man, that dude is someone I can get behind. You know what I mean?
Yes. I do. And I think, Lamar Jackson's an excuse. You know how I feel about it.
Yes, me too.
And that whole division. Joe Burrow is the best player in the division.
Wow.
When it comes to Lamar Jackson's the most explosive playmaker, right, with his feet and arm and just dynamic. When I'm talking about dynamic. But if you're just talking about quarterback that he'll beat you by time with his feet, he's got a great understanding. Matter of fact, coming out of college, I said this, Dan, because I watched every game he played his last year at least twice with LSU, at least twice. And he's got the best pocket awareness I've seen of a guy coming out of school. And I'm not talking about, you know, Herbert's success. I'm talking about pocket awareness, not who was better, who put up more yards of these guys. Pocket awareness, the ability to sidestep, reset, throw accurately, and keep your head up on the coverage without looking at the pass rush. There's a feel for presence in the pocket that, like accuracy, is very difficult to teach. And he had as good a pocket manipulation and presence of any quarterback I've seen in two decades. I mean, he is that good. And I am with you when he smokes that cigar afterwards. That, again, isn't just for camera show. It isn't. It's, dude, this is who I am. These guys are going to rally around me. Yeah, he's a guy, Dan, once again, we talk, who elevates people, coaches, players. Who elevates and takes a 7 and gets an 8.5 out of him? Who, and just, there's a believability. Guys look around and say, well, damn, if Joe's like Mikey in the Life cereal commercial, he's going to do it. I'll just follow him, and he eats it. I'm going to eat the same thing. So, to me, he is one of those cats right now. If you took a bunch of GMs and stuck them in a room and head coaches and said, quietly, nobody's going to find out what you say, where you got this dude. Dan, today, there is no way you're getting through 6-7 quarterbacks without his name being mentioned already.
I believe that.
I'm telling you. And that may, and we, I may be cheating him out of a couple spots there.
Yeah, I totally believe that. Where would you have Wentz? How do you think Wentz played yesterday? Everybody around here is killing him. I listen to you, not anybody else.
He was okay, Dan. I expect better. You know,
yeah.
I'll tell you what he is. He is the one thing about him. He has a great understanding of when to bail from the pocket. Right. There was times when I think he could have used his feet to get me some extra yards. Not just buy time and escape. He's, you know what he's got. Remember Ben Roethlisberger early in his career, that physical escape ability.
Yes.
But Wentz is a better athlete. As far as, because he's faster, and Ben was just physical and could had some way to say, dude, it looks so ugly doing it. How's he doing it? And then come up and make a play. Wentz has got that, but he's even better because he's got better feet and he's a better athlete on the edge. I think he could use his legs more to get some first downs. I thought he played fine. I missed T.Y. Hilton.
Yeah,
he had one there. He got away with one on the touchdown that was tipped. I think Dan, it bore out yesterday. I mean, another 100-yard game for Jonathan Taylor, and in order to advance in the postseason, Wentz is going to have to play like Carr did yesterday. You get my point? I mean,
yes.
There's another level to Wentz's game. Dan, we've seen the level, and that's why I'm probably not harder on him. You know how I felt coming from Philly. I liked him. I thought it was a good get if he was confident. I think he's got that. But there's going to be a few. There's about 4 or 6 decisions a game that he's going to have to make that he didn't make yesterday, that Carr made a few more. And so now you're going to go to the playoffs, and these cats are – it's a different story in single elimination. I trust Carson Wentz probably more than some do, but he can't – it just can't be a 62% or 59% game. He's got to convert third downs. He has got to make some throws that are there. And the great ones hit the simple stuff, Dan. The great ones do not miss the easy reads and the easy stuff. They just don't. When you want to advance, you got to hit me the stuff that every great player makes the ones you're supposed to make. Then there's going to be 3 or 4 in next week's game, and he'll make them against Jacksonville. And then they're going to get to January. There's going to be 3 to 4, 5 to 6 of them that I'm not teaching it. I can't coach it. He's going to have to be decisive and be very, what's the word I'm looking for, judicious with the ball, meaning 3rd and 7, you can run it, dude. Get down after 8. And if you've got T.Y. Hilton wide open, those are the ones you just can't miss, because you know who's not missing it? Brady, yeah. Rodgers, those guys, and that's the level he's trying to aspire to. He's got all the skill you want. He's a player. But make sure you hit the ones you're supposed to hit, because if he doesn't, no matter what Jonathan Taylor does in the playoffs, you're going to have your quarterback make 4 or 5 of those plays in a game. And I thought he was okay yesterday, but maybe I'm harder on him because I've seen better, and he can play better. And had he made a few extra throws and the defense had got off the field on third down and they converted a few third downs, it would have been a different result. You wouldn't even have to worry about next week, although they may not be. But it's okay to be focused and to have to play single elimination going into the playoffs. That puts pressure on your team to stay focused. But I'm a Wentz fan, but you're not going to miss those throws in the postseason in advance, Dan. They just can't.
Let me go another direction with you. What are we going to see tonight? You know, Big Ben, he's saying his last game, or all signs point to his last game. What are your thoughts?
I would expect him to go out throwing a party on that. It's fitting,
yeah,
for him to go. I would expect a good game. Listen, he's going to walk off the field, and if it's not a first ballot 5, 6 years later on the second ballot, he's going to be a Hall of Famer sooner than later, because he's quite frankly earned it. His legs aren't the same anymore, and I'm not talking about a scram. I'm just talking about the lift,
yeah,
where the ball can come out and the extra velocity. But if I was his opponent tonight, I would expect, and I would expect national television to expect really good Ben Roethlisberger tonight. Now, listen, Dan, if he goes out there and plays poorly, we already know it's time. But we know that sometimes guys going out party, you're like, okay, let's accentuate this. Let's validate. Let's stamp the last couple games of his career as last time on national television. Let's let it rip. I would expect, and if he doesn't play a good game, then they're not going to win. But I would expect one of those games where Ben cuts it loose and has a little bit of extra tonight with a little bit of adrenaline. I don't know who's going to win the game. I would expect him to play well as we give our goodbyes to him in the next couple weeks.
Yeah, I would too. You know what? There are some, you know, he's been there long, and whether you like, you know, hasn't lived a perfect life. I get, I do. Right. I totally get, none of us have, and he's hurt some people, and, you know, I get all that. But
I'm just talking about the offensive stuff. He's been a hell of a player.
That's what I'm saying. Like, you know, 18 years in one spot, a football town. He, you know, I would expect them to, I don't know about beat the hell out of anybody, but I would expect them to play really well tonight because of that.
I see a game. This could be one of those 25-38 type games for 330 yards and three touchdowns. It could be that type of game. Now, if you don't hit him tonight and you let him sit his feet, it won't just shock me at all if he has it, because he can still throw it. It's just not quite the same, and he can't carry a team on his back like we've seen him do in the past, where it's like, Ben, you got to throw 20 times in a row, and boom, 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 boom. Before you know it, he's throwing you back in. But I also know this. If you're up 2.5 touchdowns and he's got the ball with a full quarter left, they'll put it in the air, and he's had a tendency. Speaking of guys who could throw you back into it from behind, he's had it. We've seen a few clunkers in his career, but if you're just talking about on the field, if the stuff that had happened off the field would never have happened, people would be, this would be an unbelievable, they'd be celebrating him everywhere on the field with his career, Dan. And that's because he's been, and we it's rare to see a dude play that many years with one team. Rodgers may have to have it happen. Brady didn't even have it happen. We know that it's happening with Ben Roethlisberger. On the field, he's been nothing, and it seems like he's changed his life for the better. But on the field, I got nothing but praise for the guy because he's been phenomenal.
I think I told you this. I offered him a basketball scholarship. He was from 20 minutes from Bowling Green when I was a basketball coach there. I offered him a basketball scholarship after watching him for about 10 minutes based on him being 6'6", long, and an unbelievable leader. Like, I'm sitting there watching him going, holy hell, I want this guy on my team. And then the football coaches came over to watch him. I go, what are you guys doing? And they go, oh, he's going to be the best quarterback in the country. I go, oh, okay. All right. That nobody knows about or something like that. You know, I'm like, oh, okay.
Right. 18 years later out of Miami, Ohio, he ain't bad, is he?
No.
He ain't bad. Yeah, he's had a good run.
Yeah, he's had a nice run. And you know what? I anticipate him playing great. You're the best, my man. Happy New Year to you and your family, man.
Happy New Year. Look forward to next week. And go Colts. Let's get them in the postseason. Let's see what our guy Wins can do. I love you, man. Thanks.
Thanks, brother. All right. That's the great Sean Salisbury on the hotline, brought to you by Flight by Yingling. All right, we'll come back. I'm taking phone calls today. I got my Colts, what is this called? The scarf. They gave them out yesterday. I grabbed one. I ain't afraid. Colts, and more Colts. And IU basketball, and more IU basketball. Pacers.
Dan versus fan next,
too. Oh, Dan versus fan. Let's go. Who won? Don't tell me. We'll be back.
Bet Rivers Sportsbook is ready to make this football season one to remember. All season long, you can score at Bet Rivers Sportsbook with free bets, odds boosts, and more. With player props, thousands of game lines, and live in-game betting, Bet Rivers Sportsbook delivers a best-in-class sports betting experience and has an experienced customer service team to back it up. Visit Bet Rivers Sportsbook today and bet this football season with a local trusted team that puts you first. Go to BetRivers.com and be a winner. Partner of French Lick Casino Resort. Must be 21 or over to play. Gambling problem? Call 1-800-9-WITH-IT. 1-800-994-8448. Playable only in Indiana.
The winner serves all, dear.
Is this your queen?
Man, is that the fourth time?
I lost count.
But hold on. I'm a loving queen. I got McDonald's.
Big Mac and Quarter Pounder and McNuggets and...
Long live the queen.
I like the sound of that.
There's a deal for every victory at McDonald's. Order ahead on the app and get two faves, like a 10-piece McNuggets, Big Mac, Quarter Pounder, or Filet-O-Fish for just $6. Price and participation may vary. Single item at a regular price. Limited time offer.
Doctors Without Borders teams confront hard facts in conflict and crisis zones. When others look away, we step in to act. Because measles still kills more than 100,000 children every year, we're there to vaccinate more than 1 million. Because some countries have only one or two mental health professionals, we provided over 400,000 mental health consultations last year. The fact is, your support makes our life-saving work possible. Picture the impact we can have together. doctorswithoutborders.org.
Do you need to hire? Then you need Indeed. Indeed has 135 assessments to help you find the right candidates fast. Visit Indeed.com/credit.
Join us on The Fan and listen to Jason Hammer on You Bet with Bet Rivers, 7 to 8 p.m. on Thursdays, where you can get all the betting advice you would ever need.
Hannah complained of a headache. It was a rhabdomyosarcoma. Within a few days, Hannah was in treatment because we were told that the tumor was very aggressive. And it very quickly became clear that St. Jude was the ultimate place to be. So we've essentially put our lives in South Africa on hold. Incredibly blessed to be here. St. Jude is an asset to the world. The research that is developed here is offered freely to the rest of the medical world. The entire way that the place operates is just to give and to care. I think it's the kind of place that not only stands as a beacon for pediatric cancer, but I think it could teach the world a couple of lessons about how to treat people. And I think if those lessons could be learned, even in their most basic form, this world could be a better place.
St. Jude Children's Research Hospital. Finding cures, saving children. Learn more at stjude.org.
It's Kevin and Querry.
The Colts' search for a playoff bid is going to be put on hold until week number 18.
Two ways to look at it, I guess. One is to be invigorated by the fact that you're heading down the home stretch and you're still in the playoff hunt, but the other is, man, opportunity missed.
That is the worst game the Colts have played since week 3. Here you are 2 weeks before the start of the playoffs, but at the same time, it's also kind of a compliment to how well they have played.
Kevin and Querry.
Weekday mornings at 7
on 93.5 and 107.5. The Fan. It's the Dan Dockett Show, 93.5 and 107.5. The Fan.
I don't like it. DraftKings Sportsbook, DraftKings.com, Dan versus Fan. Stan, how are you?
I'm great, sir, and yourself?
I'm not good, Stan. I'm not good. Not good, well, Stan. All right, Eddie, go through it. What happened here?
All righty, Dan. So you took the Dolphins plus 3.5 against the Titans.
How'd that go?
The Titans minus 3.5 is what Stan had, so it's 1 for Stan, 0 for Dan. Yeah. You each took Cowboys minus 6. Did not happen. Arizona covered and outright won. So, Dan, you are 0-2. Stan is 1-1. You both took the Bengals and the Seahawks. Both of those hit. So, Dan, you are 2-2. Stan is 3-1. And then, Dan, you took the Vikings plus 7. And Stan took the Packers minus 7.
In my defense, I didn't know everybody was going to be out. Well, I'm just whining. So Stan, I'm just whining.
Stan was 4-1, and Dan was 2-3.
See, you know what I blame it on, Stan?
What's that?
I blame it on my producer.
Well, he's an easy target. I'll grant you that.
He is an easy target. It's like Carson Wentz here. You know what I mean? Carson Wentz, easy target. Let's blame him. Stan, how do you feel that you have stopped the win streak that I've been on since the bye? It's a 4-game win streak.
It's standemonium in January 22. and speaking of which, I got a Biggins t-shirt coming your way, brother, to celebrate.
So I'll wear it.
Send it to the studio. 2X. Right.
At least. Yeah, if you got 3, don't be afraid.
We can do 3.
I'll wear it. I will wear it for 1 week straight. That was my penance for sentence for losing to you. Send me a note. Remind me. And I will wear it on this YouTube channel every single day for a week.
I love it, man. I love it. And, hey, I have to get this in because I promised myself I ever got through. I didn't go to high school with Damon Bailey. I'm clearly much older than he, but I did play in a lot of the same barns as the Mule back in the day.
All right. Oh, you did? As the Mule, did you?
Lawrenceville, Illinois. Yeah. All my family are down that way. So
where are you from?
I'm talking legit barns. I'm here in Indianapolis, but all my cousins went to school with Marty.
Well, if you didn't go to school with Damon Bailey, you're one of the very few that lives in central Indiana. Appreciate you, man. Thanks, Stan. Send me that t-shirt. I'll wear it every day. That's my gift.
Will do, brother. Thanks, man.
Thank you. There you go. It's a great part of the world down there. It is, man. Colts last night, they got beat. Derek Carr came in, hit Hunter Renfrow. Did you see this, though? Call in. Eddie will be answering the phones, 317-239-1070. I don't know if you guys saw this. There's two things that happened in stupidity yesterday. One of them was Antonio Brown. Now, look, I think Antonio Brown's got problems, and I think Antonio Brown probably has problems for a long time now. But here's where I put a caveat. I did see, and I don't know if this is true or not, apparently it is, that he dropped an album. He walked out on his team. Raise your hand right now. I'm going to go to YouTube chat. Raise your hand on the YouTube chat. Those of you that haven't, and Eddie, you can include this, haven't taken off all your clothes and walked out on a job. I haven't. I know you all have. Come on. Come on. You all walked there. You all ripped off all your clothes, gone in the middle. See, I think this. I think that Antonio Brown needs help, and I hope he gets it. A lot of guys have wanted to. If you have taken off all your clothes and walked out on a job, 317-239-1070. This is the number for you. I have not. I have done this show naked, which it was because of the Patriots lost a game. I don't know if it was on YouTube, but a girl came up here, a woman. I don't know. What's the proper term? I don't know. I'm 100 years old. It was a girl. A lady came up here with a camera, and I'm like, wait a second. She goes, oh, you're really naked? I go, yes. You can't do that. Yes, no, but if the Colts lose to the Patriots Monday, I will be in here with only a scarf on to hide my nipples.
Poor Jimmy.
Globetrotter said, I dropped my gloves and walked off the mound. Does that count? Yeah. What do you got, Brad? How are you?
Hey, Dan, thanks for the call.
You got it.
You're right on point with the pass rush. I said it 2 weeks ago. Yeah. We need people other than Payton Buckner to step up in big games. But I think a more obvious concern to me from what I've seen this year is on obvious passing situations, especially on third down, our offensive line is terrible. It seems like Wentz, I think he only got sacked once yesterday, but the overthrow where T.Y. was wide open, I think that maybe got in his head a little bit. But I've been waiting to see explosiveness in our offense for 4 years. I rarely see double moves or no huddle. I don't know. Maybe Frank can get it together week 17. But I want to see more explosion. Go ahead.
Well, no, I don't disagree with you. Like, I thought for a while that this was really going. I thought the offensive line was pretty good, particularly in the run game. But, man, for being such a dynamic offensive line, that pass protection ain't great. It really isn't.
No.
It's and, again, you said it. I mean – you can try to trick teams, but when you're trying to win and it's third and nine, that's when you got to earn your money as an offensive line, because they know, we all know, right?
Right.
One
thing I was going to say, I know we drafted Strawn. He's a big body guy. Wentz loves bigger body guys. Why not put him in there and let Wentz throw a go route? I mean,
I'm not going to lie to you. I'm not going to question that, because they see they see it every day. So I'm not really going to question that, but I understand your point. Appreciate you, Brad. Yeah. Thank you.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
Dave Carroll says, it wasn't a job, but I walked out of a varsity baseball doubleheader in just my sliding pants and undershirt trying to find a ride home. My buddy Demetrius, he quit at halftime of the Crown Point Maryville game. He didn't get in the first half. I looked over and he was sitting next to me. Hey, Dan, I got to retract this from Dave again. I got to retract my statement that the Bengals don't scare me. They scare the hell out of me after seeing what Jimmy Big Nuts is doing. Daryl, what do you got? Hello.
Hey, thanks for taking my call.
You got it.
I'll be quick. I just want to make three points that I think you guys already touched on, but just your opinion from looking at from this aspect. So with AB, none of us ever has really taken off our clothes or did in that aspect. But in his defense, just trying to be devil advocate, they said he was hurt or whatever, and they want him to go back in because he was hurt. Hmm. They basically said, well, if you don't go back in, then you're not on the team. So if you're at your job and you tell your employee you're sick, they're like, well, if you don't work, you're fired. But you're like, well, I'm going home, I'm sick. So kind of looking at it from that aspect.
Yeah, maybe. But I've also heard that he had this all set up to go and drop a rap video. He was in a car. I mean, I don't know, man. Yeah, that's, he ended up in New York, and he had a police escort to a plane. And this seems like it was planned. I feel sorry for him, Darnell. Okay,
And then my other thing, yeah. Carson. Now, I don't know why on this one it seems like everybody gives Carson a pass. The other caller pointed out that was big. He missed T.Y. Mm-hmm. Hilton wide open. And it was at least three other passes that were key that he missed, because if that happens, we win the game. And then lastly, what about Frank Wright being conservative at the end and doing those three run plays? You got to take a shot in the end zone instead of going for the field goal. And thanks for taking my call.
Hey, thank you, Darnell. No, I agree with you. A lot of people are talking about that, the conservative nature. Michael, what do you got?
Hey, Dan.
Hey, Dan. Hey.
Happy New Year.
Same to you. Thank you.
Uh-huh. Hey, I was wondering, it seemed like the Colts didn't have an answer for that Marcus Mariota yesterday.
What did he really do? Like, what? Well, he threw a pass. It got incomplete. I don't know. I don't think he was a factor. I really don't.
He ran a couple times and got him a first down or something. But
I'm going to go to Jay-Z. Colts had 99 problems, and Mariota wasn't one, I don't think. I mean, look, he came in. It was nice. It was cute, but I'm not buying that.
Okay.
Appreciate you, brother. Uh-huh. Marcus, he was all right. I mean, did he score a touchdown? What did he do? Hey, Dan, this is a great question for you two geniuses over there. The great Brendan Cook. Combination of Jimmy Cook and Brendan King.
Come on.
Yeah.
I feel like you wouldn't make that mistake by now.
I make it every day. I mean, my wife is like, I call her, call her Jackie one time, my ex-wife. That was not good. All right, do you know this? Here's a question for you two guys. Eddie, get your fingers ready. This is a great question. Has any NFL team ever made the playoffs? The answer's got to be yes, with a losing record at home. That's a good question.
It's a great question.
You know what the Colts are?
At home?
Yeah.
Probably close to 500, right?
4-5.
Yeah.
How about that? Man.
So the question is, has a team ever made the playoffs?
Has a team ever made the playoffs with a losing record at home? I got to believe so.
I feel like yes, right?
Yeah, but that's hard, man.
I mean, I don't know. League's been around a long time.
League's a long time. It's not a short, it's not a new league.
Right. It's not like the NFL has forever had like the true home field advantage. Right?
I mean,
in the 80s, it's not like you go on the road, it's automatic.
Don't besmirch the 80s.
No, You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I do. And I would say that I'll say this. In the 2000s, I'd say somebody has. Eddie's on this, man. Eddie's face went forward. He's in a screen right now. But the Colts are 4-5 at Akasa.
How bad does the Seahawks loss look right now?
Oh my God, right? I mean, we thought the Seahawks were good. They came in. That was opening game.
Yes.
That was after he had a lot of time to prepare.
Is that Russell Wilson's best game of the year?
He had a good one last night.
But it's against the Lions.
Yeah, I know, but it's still a game. I mean,
still a game.
We love the Colts, but somebody might say, well, it's against Colts. Colts are 9-7.
It's true.
I got your answer.
Give me the answer.
Last year, the Washington football team made the postseason, and they were 3-5 at home. And they had a losing record of 7-9.
How'd they make the playoffs? They won the division. Yep. That's right.
That's how
bad it was. Oh, my gosh. All right. Well, the answers come quick. How are the Florida Panthers doing?
Doing great. Yeah. We're doing great. So they got out of the COVID Christmas break. They won their last two. Dan Dockich, do you know what the Florida Panthers beat the Tampa Bay Lightning by 4 days ago?
9-3.
Did you see that?
Yeah, I did. Yeah.
That's some revenge for us from last year.
That's a hockey game I can get down.
That's an ass whooping.
It is an ass whooping. All right, yes or no, Colts make the playoffs?
Yes.
Give me a score.
In Jacksonville?
Yeah.
Dan, you know Jacksonville is going to play PO'd after what they just took.
I think Jacksonville's done.
Somebody's got to be mad in that locker room. Somebody's got to be mad in that locker room.
Okay.
Right? You should go coach that team.
You got to have pride. They had a pretty good coach. They didn't like him.
No.
Go ahead.
Colts better play PO'd. So.
Well, let me put it to you this way. Colts lose, I'm doing the show naked.
Remotely?
Right here. Wearing only my sash, my Colts towel. My Colts, what is this thing called?
I think you got to wear one of the Borat swimsuits.
I should.
You know what I'm saying?
I should. Yeah, I should. I did it, you know, years ago, and I'll never forget when I said it, and then I'm watching the Patriots, and they lose. Maybe it was the Jacksonville. I don't know. Yeah, I get that people say that Jacksonville has beaten the Colts, but I don't get into that. What I get into is, what are you doing this year? And I don't think Jacksonville really figured anything out by firing Urban Meyer, at least based on yesterday. Here's another one for you, Eddie. When's the last time somebody dropped 50 in an NFL game? Maybe the Patriots did this year.
They just did.
No, I know yesterday.
Oh.
No, has anybody else dropped 50 this year on a team? I feel like the Patriots, or maybe it was the Bills,
the Cowboys just scored 56 against the football
team. That's what it was.
Last week.
Yes. Yeah. I knew I'd seen it pretty recently. Yes, and the Patriots scored 54 against the Jets. Yeah, like, used to be in the day, Nebraska would play like Tulsa and score like 80.
And then Seattle scored 51 yesterday, too, against the Lions.
They did.
There are a lot of 50 burgers out here.
The Football Lions. The Football Lions under Dan Campbell, who everybody thought was, well, who's the coach of the year in the NFL? Eddie.
I want to go with Zach Taylor just because of the way they've won the AFC North. They weren't predicted to win it.
He was on the hot seat 10 minutes ago. Who you got?
I mean, if they end up making a run, it's got to be McVay, right?
No.
No?
I think it's Vrabel. Vrabel took a team that didn't have A.J. Brown a lot of the year. Julio Jones has been nothing. Derrick Henry's been out, and they're going to get the number one seed if they win this week.
How crazy is it, too, when you look at their losses? I mean, they lost to the Jets.
And the Texans. Like,
oh, my God.
Yes. I'm telling you. You think about who they've lost to. No, I'm with you. I mean, it's crazy, but I think Vrabel's got to be in that conversation. I think Zach Taylor's a good one. I don't know. Is Belichick there? No. I mean... But I'll tell you this, I think Vrabel's done it. When you really look at it, Vrabel's done a hell of a job. They've played 88 people this year. It's the most in modern NFL history.
Mm.
This isn't like college where you got 100 guys. When you go to the NFL games, you sit there and go, man, there's not very many people on the sideline. Because 11 are out there. There's 52 or 53 on the roster. You go to a college football game, it's like, I think I dressed.
It's packed.
Yeah, I'm like, oh, shoot, I got a little time in there as a walk-on. Honest to God.
When I was living in Idaho, Boise State asked me a dress.
Did they?
No, but it was that level.
Lee Corso came to my house to ask me to come out for football after my freshman year. My father's exact question, have you seen the boy? I weighed about 110. Now I've eaten myself. Now,
is that how bad Lee Corso needed players?
I don't know. I would imagine.
What position did he ask you to play?
He wanted me to play safety. He said, we can bulk him up. He'll be a great safety. My dad's like, you know, he runs a 10 flat 40. So like, the boy can't run.
Your dad said, not so fast, my friend?
My dad did. All right, we're going to come back. I got to take some phone calls on the Colts. We got a couple people calling. Thank you, Brendan. 317-239-1070.
With an easy refinance, our clients, on average, save over $350 a month. TheHomeLoanExpert.com.
NMLS number 1326241.
Do you really want to go through another year with that awful joint pain? Well, don't do it. Resolve right now to get yourself moving again for 2022. I'm Kevin Bowen, and it is time to call our friends at QC Kinetics. Non-surgical regenerative treatments for joint pain. We're talking lasting results using natural biologics. No surgery, no pain meds, no steroids, and no downtime. This is really exciting stuff. Regenerative treatments that actually encourage your body to heal itself using highly concentrated natural biologics. Patients rave about it. For hip pain relief, knee pain, shoulder, back pain, all of those things. Don't let them keep giving you steroids. Don't let them tell you that surgery is your only option. Get a free second opinion at QC Kinetics and do it now. Imagine your life in 2022 without pain. So do us a favor. Call the local medical professionals at QC Kinetics. You will not regret it. 463-235-7160. That is 463-235-7160.
We're here early before they wake up. We stay late. We stay informed. We invest in the latest technology.
We take the time to train the next generation of doctors and nurses. We work together to make sure we heal their bodies and their minds.
We do this not because it's our job, but because this is about our veterans' lives. This is our mission. More than 300,000 of us working as one, together with families and loved ones. No matter where they live in this country, we'll be there.
We all come together and stand together to serve our veterans. We stand strong, united. Stand with us in caring for our veterans.
Parents, teachers, school board members, do you want your school to experience the richness of academic freedom or the constraints of a one-size-fits-all federal mandate called Common Core Standards? Advocates for Academic Freedom is for educational excellence and local control of your school. Come join the fight for your children's education. You can contact us at advocatesforacademicfreedom.org or call 1-715-234-5072.
We all play a role in keeping our community safe.
Every day, we move in and out of each other's busy lives.
It's easy to take for granted all the little moments that make up our everyday.
Some are good,
others not so much.
But that's life.
It's when something doesn't seem quite right
that it's time to pay attention.
Because only you know what's not supposed to be in your everyday.
So protect your everyday.
If you see something suspicious, say something to local authorities.
I'm Sherry Shepherd. You probably know me best as a co-host on The View. More importantly, I'm a mom. If you're pregnant or a new mom, you can get timely expert information to help keep your baby healthy, something every mother wants. Through a free service called Text for Baby, women get health tips sent directly to their cell phones to help them care for their babies through the first year. Just text BABY, B-A-B-Y, to 511-411. That's BABY, B-A-B-Y, to 511-411 for the health of your baby.
My grades were bad. I would, like, get D's and C's.
I appeared to be doing good at my school life, but if you would see me at home, it would have been a completely different story.
I mean, it was just rough focusing on school when your mother is somebody you have to take care of. It got worse and worse and worse throughout the years.
There are students who need somebody.
They can trust someone, and it could be the first person they've ever trusted in their life.
Communities and Schools is lowering America's dropout rate by helping more than 1.3 million kids every year get whatever they need to succeed in school.
If something was going on at home, we would go just stop by Miss Liberty's office and talk to her.
Communities and Schools vouched for me when everyone else had lost hope.
You can help change the picture of education right here in your community and across the nation. Visit communitiesandschools.org.
I hear people say we can't save every kid, but I think that we can.
AFC playoff picture coming into form. We'll take a deeper look at it. And Purdue, Wisconsin to talk about Pacers chat as well. All tomorrow, 7 a.m. Kevin and Query, 93.5, 107.5 The Fan.
Open up the champagne. Pop. It's my house. Come on. Turn it up. Hear a knock.
Sack up. It's the Dan Dockett Show on 93.5 and 107.5, The Fan.
Hey, welcome back. A lot of discussion tonight. Purdue does play Wisconsin. A lot of talking about the Colts. I did not love what the Colts did. I got to... Darryl, what do you got? Let's go to the phones. I want phones all day. Let's go.
Dan, Happy New Year.
Same to you, my friend. Yes, sir.
Hey, I got a little NBA wager for you to make. You know Franz Wagner very well, don't you?
Yes.
How do you like the way he's playing in the NBA right now?
I think he's rookie of the year. Can you find that somewhere?
Yes. We've just put $500 down to win $9,000. Right now it dropped from when I made the bet. Right now it's plus $1,400 on FanDuel.
No kidding.
Yep. Mm-hmm. He dropped, 38 against Milwaukee the other night?
He's been great, man. No, he's been great. Absolutely great.
The only other kid he's got to compete against is the kid from Detroit. I mean, if he stays healthy, he should be a shoo-in to win the year.
You know what I'm doing right now? I'm going over to DraftKings, and I'm taking a look. What do you think about the Pacers? Pretty good, huh?
You know, as Charles Barkley would say, terrible, terrible, terrible.
Hey, you're the guy that when I was sitting there jumping up and down, standing on my head and crapping snowballs about the Colts, you're the guy that said, not so fast, my friend.
Yeah, but they're not there yet, are they?
No, that's what I'm saying. You're the guy that said, slow it down a little bit. No question.
Exactly. Carson, they got to do something with Carson Wentz, do some more play action. He just can't. It's like he doesn't know when that pocket's collapsing. He just gets himself in trouble. It drives me crazy. I'm yelling at the TV, you know?
No, I get it. I do. I 100% get it. No, I do. I think you're all right, Evan Mobley is the favorite for Rookie of the Year. I got plus 900 right now.
I just brought out my FanDuel account, and right now on FanDuel, he's plus 1,400.
All right. Appreciate you, brother. Thank you.
Have a good one, brother.
Spencer, what say you?
Wanted to get your thoughts on Purdue-Wisconsin, and just kind of something I noticed I thought was terrible by both teams in the Penn State-IU game last night. Penn State won, but they had absolutely no movement on offense, and they were just running like a ball screen top of the key half the time and just driving it into a static defense. And I just don't understand why that's kind of the state of college basketball right now without ball reversals.
You know what? They hand off. It is. It's they hand off. Everybody runs the same offense, Spencer. It drives me nuts. That's why I like watching Matt's Painter's teams. I mean, they'll get to ball screen, but there's going to be some people movement there too. You know what I mean? They're going to come off a screen. I think tonight's game is going to be a little bit more higher scoring than what people think. Purdue, I think, has scored under 70 one time, and it was in their loss to Rutgers. I think Purdue's going to get to 80. I think a couple of things. I'll let you go, and I'll keep talking about Purdue-Wisconsin tonight. Here's the deal. The over-under is 140. I'm going to bet the over. Now, let me go this route with you. One of the things about Wisconsin is they're an improved team. They're a team that has a guy that's probably going to be a first-round draft choice, maybe a lottery pick in Jonathan Davis. And Jonathan Davis can go get himself 20. And what's his face? Davison, who's been there forever. But I love Purdue's ability to go up and down the floor, and I don't care who it's against. I really don't. And that's one of the things that I think you have to do. When you look at the great teams across college basketball that have won championships, they're not scoring in the 50s. I mean, Purdue scored 77 and 79 back-to-back against Butler and then Incarnate Word, and that's like low scoring. They came back with 104 against Nicholls State. Now, you got to listen to me here. Purdue scored 68 points against Rutgers. That's it. 77, 82, 93 against Florida State, 80 against Villanova. You know, 97, 93 against North Carolina, 96, 96, 92 against Indiana State. I mean, Purdue has scored one time under 70. And if I took it a little deeper for you, Purdue has scored one time under 75. Now, think about that. I'm not saying Purdue's played the greatest teams. Don't get me wrong. I don't think Florida State's great. I think Villanova is much better now than they were when they played Purdue. But the truth of the matter is, I think that Purdue is going to score some points in this game. I don't think this is going to be a typical 58-56 Purdue-Wisconsin game when Wisconsin was playing Packland. I think Purdue's going to get to 80, and I like the over.
So the fact that Wisconsin, you know, likes to play a little bit slower doesn't scare you at all?
That's what I just said. No, they want to. But if they're smart, they're not going to try. You can't. Look, here's the way Wisconsin can play slow and win a game. You got to hit 55 to 60% of your threes, because if you're going to play slow, Purdue's not. I don't care who it is. They're going to play fast. They're going to go, and it just doesn't matter. All right, I'll be right back. I got to clean up a mess that I made here a minute ago, and it's an incredible mess right here in the hallway with coffee.
It's Kevin and Querry.
The Colts' search for a playoff bid is going to be put on hold until week number 18.
Two ways to look at it, I guess. One is to be invigorated by the fact that you're heading down the home stretch and you're still in the playoff hunt, but the other is, man, opportunity missed.
That is the worst game the Colts have played since week 3. Here you are 2 weeks before the start of the playoffs, but at the same time, it's also kind of a compliment to how well they have played.
Kevin and Querry.
Weekday mornings at 7
on 93.5 and 107.5. The Fan.
BetMGM, the king of sportsbooks, welcomes you with the lock of the year. Simply place a $10 moneyline wager on either Cleveland or Pittsburgh. If either team scores a touchdown in the game, you'll win $200 in free bets, regardless of your bet's outcome. Just use the bonus code THEFAN200, that's all one word, capital T, capital F, when you make your first bet. Enjoy football like never before and earn M Life rewards that you can redeem for rooms and dining at MGM resorts nationwide. Download the app or go to BetMGM.com. And again, use that bonus code, THEFAN200, to win $200 in free bets if either Pittsburgh or Cleveland scores a touchdown. Visit BetMGM.com for terms and conditions. 21 years of age or older to wager. Indiana only. New customer offer. All promotions are subject to qualification and eligibility requirements. Rewards issued as non-withdrawable free bets or site credit. Free bets expire 7 days from issuance. If you or someone you know has a gambling problem and wants help, call 1-800-9-WITH-IT.
Hi, it's Steve Mann. Have you heard the commercials for the Mark Patrick Stop Smoking Seminars? And they said only $49.99 and it could work for you. So I thought, that's not even a week's worth of smoking. So I went. And guess what? It did work for me. You know, my friends and family are still amazed. I quit smoking. I didn't have cravings, anxiety, or weight gain. Listen, I don't know how it works, but I know it works because I'm living proof and it's 100% guaranteed. So what do you got to lose? I'll tell you what you got to lose. A very bad habit.
Join Mark Patrick Seminars and stop smoking now without cravings, irritability, weight gain, or your money back. Only $49.99 guaranteed. Designed to work without anxiety, irritability, or weight gain for only $49.99, become a non-smoker. That's right. Seminar times are 8 to 10 p.m. on Thursday, January 20th at the Holiday Inn Hotel in Carmel. And 2 to 4 p.m. on Saturday, January 22nd at the La Quinta Inn and Suites Hotel in Indianapolis. Registration 30 minutes before seminar.
Yankee legend Bernie Williams has a personal message to share.
Idiopathic pulmonary fibrosis, or IPF, is a rare and serious lung disease that affected my dad. Its symptoms, which include shortness of breath, fatigue, and a dry, persistent cough, are similar to other more common conditions like COPD, which means that IPF is often misdiagnosed. There's no cure for IPF, but there are treatments that can help slow disease progression. If you think you or a loved one may have IPF, don't wait. Visit breathlessipf.com to learn more and talk to a pulmonologist today.
Hi, I'm Ryan Kelly with thehomeloanexpert.com. There's never been a better time for a cash-out refinance. Thehomeloanexpert.com.
NMLS number 1326-241.
93.5 and 107.5. The Fan.
WIBC HD2 W298BB. WIBC HD3 W228CX. Indianapolis.
Soccer Saturday featuring Indy 11. If this is your football, this is your show. Saturday at 9 on The Fan. It's the Dan Dockett Show, 93.5 and 107.5. The Fan.
Hey, welcome back and Happy New Year to everybody as we start hour three of the new year on an absolutely beautiful day. I know it's cold, but I'll take cold as long as the sun is shining. Couple of things. You know, one of the things that I'm kind of tired of is when somebody gives an opinion, we immediately attack the person giving the opinion. Kirk Herbstreit, he gave his opinion. Now, you may not like his opinion, but at least it's something worth discussing. Here's my opinion on what Kirk said. First, I don't care any longer if people decide they're going to opt out. I don't care if they opt in. And I don't think Matt Corral, the quarterback at Mississippi, has any bearing on either of it. What I like is the theater of college football. Like, anybody telling me, even a little bit, that frickin' Purdue and Tennessee wasn't a great time, or the Rose Bowl wasn't a great time, or the whole weekend wasn't a great time, you're nuts. So if you want to opt out, great. If you don't want to opt out, I'm good with that too. But the game will go on, and it is absolutely fantastic theater. And that's what I'm looking for. I'm looking for fantastic theater. I don't care whether or not there's 100 bowl games and everybody wants to say players are exploited. They're not. Players love to play, man. And what I saw was this. I saw players for basically every game that I watched playing their ass off. That's what I saw. Now, maybe you saw different. I don't know. But I know what I saw. I saw guys balling. I saw guys getting after it. I saw guys playing hard. And frankly, if you want to opt out, opt out. If you don't want to opt out, don't opt out. That's how I look at it. But we can't have this discussion, right? Kirk Herbstreit said that based on his conversations with coaches. And you know this, and I know this. We all know this. Desmond Howard getting as much crap as Kirk Herbstreit? He said the same thing. We all know the reason to that. But the truth of the matter is, I don't care. I honestly don't. Because the game is going to go on. The theater is going to be great. And you know what? If you don't like it, don't watch. But I like it. Are there too many bowl games? Maybe for you, but not for me. Should guys play? Are they meaningless? Well, I do like this argument that a lot of people made. And one of them is that, you know, when Herb Street, when I was in college, guys, frankly, there's only 19 bowl games. Now there's an S ton of bowl games, right? Now there's a ton. Now there's, I don't even know how many. I mean, there's 44 of them. So I get it. But I don't begrudge Herb Street for saying it. I mean, it's his opinion. But everybody loses their mind, right? Because a guy gave an opinion that doesn't fly in the direction of the way the wind blows. And we are all supposed to fly in that direction. We are all supposed to, you know, run towards everybody else's opinion. And if not, there's no sense. There's no sense at all in debating it. That idiot, Chris Corman, who used to work for the Star, I mean, nah, whatever the paper is in Bloomington, that dumbass, he never walked in a gym other than to have a jock on his head. And he's the guy, well, it's terrible. No, it's not. No, it's old, it's outdated, it's lazy. No, it's not. I mean, it's not lazy because they went and talked to coaches, and this is what coaches are saying. Now, you can come back and criticize the coach. That's fine. But a smarter, unlazy thing to do would be to ask a question, why are coaches saying that? That's like the adult thing to do. But Chris Corman and all these guys, you know, they got to act like they're superior. And they don't even know whether to put a jock on their head or on their ass. And those are the two options for them. So it's ridiculous. We can't even have a conversation. Seriously. We cannot even have a conversation. I don't have any problem with guys opting out. I don't have any problem with guys opting in. I don't have any problem with the number of bowl games. I don't. I like them because I know players like them. You know, guys like me want to do, not me necessarily, because I'm beyond that, but there was a time when I would have said, man, if I could just put that IU uniform on one more time. Seriously. There was a time of that. And frankly, I don't feel that way anymore. But they get to put the uniform on one more time. So instead of bitching about it, good for them. Did you see this in the NBA? John Lucas is the Mother Teresa of the NBA. John Lucas has done more for more people than with addiction in the NBA than maybe any human being alive. Look up John Lucas and you'll find that he battled addiction. I'm going to get back to the Colts in a minute, but this is why the NBA is totally unwatchable. This is why I have no respect for the NBA. I used to. Everybody knows I was a big NBA guy. John Lucas is an assistant coach. If you want to know who John Lucas is, he basically is the first guy that had substance problems. And John dealt with them. He went out, made himself better, helped a ton of people. He's been a head coach in the NBA. He's basically been in the NBA since 1975, I think. Played in the professional tennis. But he's had a lot of off-field problems. And John Lucas is a guy who really, his legacy is bigger than anything that he did in basketball. He has a wellness and aftercare substance recovery program for athletes. Now he's an assistant coach after being a head coach, a lot of different things. So he's got these two idiots on his team. Now there's a difference between what Antonio Brown did and what Kevin Porter Jr. did. So John Lucas, who's basically the Mother Teresa of pro basketball, tells these two clowns on the Rockets, Kevin Porter Jr., who's been in a pain in the ass wherever he's been, and another clown named Christian Wood. He calls him out at halftime. An argument ensues. Guys are mad. Porter does what Porter does, which is act like an idiot, throw an object. Listen to this. He gets in his car and leaves. The other dude was late to warm-ups. He informed coaches at halftime he don't want to play because he got in an argument. This is the kind of entitled, whiny-ass baby we have in the NBA. And that's why I have no interest. Pacers are like this. They just don't get in arguments. They just don't try. They just don't play. But honest to God, you get tired of listening to a coach who is literally the Mother Teresa of the NBA tries to straighten out two idiots, and guess what? These two idiots can't handle it because why? Nobody ever has. It's really unbelievable. It really is. So there you go. Honest to God. So they'll be back. And I watched what fans react. Oh, we got to get Christian Wood back. Really? There is nobody on the Rockets that you got to have back. Kevin Porter Jr. has been kicked off of everything. Seriously. Everything. And yet somehow people are dumb enough to want him back in Houston. That tells you why the Rockets stink. All right, let me go back to the Colts. I get it. It's easy, right? It's easy to blame Carson Wentz. And all people say is, well, you know, he didn't hit T.Y. Hilton. And you're right. He didn't hit T.Y. Hilton. But, man, a lot went into that game. How about not coming out ready to play? How about coming out right from the jump when you got fans all excited, you got a packed house, you got people standing up, but you got all kind of things going on. And next thing you know, boom, 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 our vaunted defense just gives up a touchdown. I mean, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12-play drive. 12-play drive that basically takes half of the first period. A 12-play drive that took 7 minutes and 9 seconds. There's your ball game. Look, I know the Colts. Everybody knows teams are going to fight back. Everybody knows guys are going to try. You know. But the truth of the matter is, I think that the Colts came out, as T.Y. Hilton said, you know what? We didn't come out ready to play. We didn't. So, you know. Here, that's a player. That ain't one of these clowns that covers them that always cover the ass of the people here. That's a 9-7 team right now that has 7 Pro Bowlers. Now, I'm just saying. All right? I'm just saying 9-7, 6 Pro Bowlers, and we think we're the greatest team in football. I got them going to the Super Bowl. Steve, what do you got?
Hey, Danny, how are you?
Good, buddy.
Happy New Year. Just a couple quick observations, and my brother actually pointed it out to me this morning. I'm like, yeah, you're right. So I know you said you were at the game, so you didn't get to see it on TV, but I noticed it after he said it. Several times throughout the game when they would show pictures of Wentz after a play and then Braden Smith when he got his 2 stupid holding calls, if you looked at their faces, they were both, like, extremely red and flush looking. So I don't know if there still weren't. Maybe, you know, we aren't being told the whole story. You know, and Wentz kept wiping his face, which I've never seen him do before during the
game. So you're saying you think they might be sick?
I'm thinking they. I'm not saying they're sick. I'm just saying maybe there's something a little more that we weren't being told or aren't being told about their true health condition.
Well, I guarantee you there is. Now, I don't know whether it's good or bad, but I guarantee you, number one, they are cleared, so they're fine. And number two, I guarantee you that we aren't told everything, and we shouldn't be told everything. I appreciate you. Look, there's a lot of things that went into this yesterday. My Southern office, who is among the smartest people, no, he is the smartest person that I know, he said, hey, look, whenever you see that nervous clapping, and he's so right, that shows that there is a lack of confidence, and that's all you saw. I went back and watched the TV tape, so I know what you're talking about. Look, I don't know. I'm not going to presume to know everybody's health status. I just know this. In the modern NFL, you're going to have to play through quarantine. You're going to have to play through not being at practice, just the way it is. Now, we can all hearken back to where you needed 17 practices a year. NBA teams aren't practicing right now. They got like 25 guys on the roster, and they're just hoping to get 9 in there. And this is all going to end pretty soon because of this COVID thing will be gone. This variant, not gone, but everybody in professional sports basically will have had this. And then you get the 90 days. You know what I'm saying? But I will say this, on a bigger note, I wonder where's the pass rush. Chappie and I have been wondering where's the pass rush for a while. You drafted pass rush. I get it. I do. I understand that you want pass rush. I understand that Quiddy Pay had 1 sack, so all of a sudden all the guys that don't like me are, oh, you know, Quiddy Pay is great. Oh, okay, he's great.
I mean, they came out
early.
Hold on.
But the truth of the matter is you got to have some pass rush. And if you don't have pass rush, you got no chance in this league. Now, if you're going to draft pass rush, one of the things that you got to do is you got to get it out of there immediately. Like, how long are you waiting? Like, people say, well, you know, they're just rookies. Okay. Well, how long are you waiting? Are you waiting 10 years, 5 years, 3 years, 2 years? You know, there's a lot of guys that come into this league and they are ready to play. They're going. Like, they're not messing around. And you draft guys and you say, well, these are our guys. I love him, blah, 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 blah. I don't know. I honestly don't know. What I do know is you better find it. I got a great friend, Cam Cefali, that sits there and he goes, hey, a blitz? Anything? Anything? And he ain't lying. He's not. I mean, where you got to invent it. Remember when Charlie Weiss said schematic advantage? Now, that was crap. But you got to scheme something up if your players aren't good enough. That's all I'm saying. You got to scheme something up. And like, I get it. We all want to say, hey, Eberflus is great. They're 9-7. That's all I'm going to tell you. They're 9-7. You know what I mean? Now, that's all I'm going to tell you. I get it. It's the greatest team with the greatest people. I love their people. They're great people. And Brandon says we blitzed a lot in the last 2 weeks. Not in the last 2 minutes. Not in the last 2 minutes. And I agree, John Napier. I watched that. Look what the Bengals did to the Mahomes. I'm just telling you. You sit back, you get your ass kicked. Period. That's a fact. And if you're going to draft it, at what point do we here in Indy, at what point do we say, man, these drafts have got to help? Quiddy Pay out of place. So what's this one guy's a pain in the ass? I forget his name. But he's like, oh, well, Dawkins doesn't understand football because Quiddy Pay got a third of a sack. Okay, where was he late? Dawkins understands late. Dawkins understands one very, 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 very important thing about sports. Big possums walk late. Period. Big possums walk late. A lot of 3 o'clock hitters out there. A lot of them. And I got all these guys, well, Quiddy Pay. Oh, really? Where was he late? How did that go late? Did that work out late? I didn't see it. If it did, maybe it did. I don't know. I mean, when it came time, now maybe, again, here you are. Listen to this. In the biggest game of the year, and now the same guy says listen to this. Same guy says about Brown, if he has CTE, then I hope he gets help. If not, I hope he burns his money faster than Allen Iverson and is forced to recognize reality. People wish that on people. But this guy, well, Dawkins doesn't understand. No, Dawkins understands pretty good. And one of the things Dawkins understands is, Sean, you don't like me. Why are you tweeting me? Don't. I've read your stuff. Don't. Leave. Anyway. Dan, so they're 9-7. You got them picked to go to the Super Bowl. I do. Before the loss yesterday. Now, I reserve the right to change. If you're not going to play good, then I don't want to hear it. But yes, I do. Before yesterday, I thought they were playing better than anybody in the AFC. Now, because I'm not an idiot, I regroup and I watch and I go, wait a second. 2 weeks ago, I didn't mind going to the Bengals. Now, hold the phone. That's a hell of a team. That's a team, man. And if you don't have pass rush, what's Joe Burrow going to do to you? Seriously, what's Joe Burrow going to do? Joe Burrow went for 1,000 yards against the Ravens and against the freaking Chiefs. Now, I don't think the Chiefs' defense is great. Don't get me wrong. But damn. Hey, Dan, they blitzed on 3rd and 10. Maniac whiffed on Carr. Yeah. No, he's not going to mention that. Doyle's not going to mention that. I don't care. I mean, it can be a, it doesn't matter to me. Look, this is January. I'm not punching down. The star writers can write what they want. They're insignificant. There's nothing about and no, there's nothing there that they know or think. How do they know? So I'm not even going there. If they go 10-7, and John G says 10-7 and 1-done. If they go 10-7, 1-done, is this a good year? Jimmy or Eddie, is this a good year? 10-7, 1-done?
No.
I don't think so either.
The goal was to win the division.
You got
to
win something. Something. Right? I mean, I don't. Hey, look. I get it. I don't think anybody would say, you know what somebody might say, Eddie? Somebody might say, well, after the way they started. No, it's on them that they started this way. Don't we have any freaking pride around here? Look, now, you go 10-7. First off, you won me some money. Second off, you won me more money because then you made the playoffs. So I'm very happy about that. But, and you go to the AFC Championship game, good year. Yeah, good year. Yeah. But I mean, 10-7, 1-done is Jimmy. Who's 10-7, 1-done, and who's the most mediocre? I don't know.
Dallas.
Yeah, but it seems like Dallas has won the division because it's a lousy division. Yeah, I feel like that's giving the Colts too much credit. I don't know, but you know what we're gonna hear? Let me tell you what we're gonna hear. You know what we're going to hear? Great draft. Oh, my God. This guy's the best. Great draft. Oh, okay. Oh, my God. Did you see who they picked up in free agency? Hey, Dan, 1-done after 10-7 would be a horse bleep year. I mean, you know what's going to happen. The payroll boys are all going to be out there. Look, you can bitch about Carson Wentz all you want, but Eddie, you know who's going to be the quarterback?
Carson Wentz.
Thank you. My boy Dale Speckman, here's what I'm tired of hearing. I've been saying this for a long time. Dale Speckman says, Dan, I'm tired of hearing about this. Great defense. Best offensive line. Great coach. Great GM. I agree Dale does with this MVP caliber running back. And all that, we're 9-7. Dan and Dale played a lot of football, man. Quiddy Pay is not good, at least not now. All his sacks have come with help. He hasn't made anybody look bad. I know. Look, I thought they would win. I thought they were playing great. I'm going to watch Hard Knocks on Wednesday. I'm going to fall back in love with them. And they're going to go 10-7, and we're going to see what the hell's going on. If they do go 1-done, if they do go 1-done, you're 10-8. It's from my friend Kevin Wolf. Pay has 3 1/3 sack, no moves, tries to bull rush, 53 did whiff on a quarterback. Yeah, he did. Look, I will say this, and I think you guys will agree with this. Colts got 99 problems, and I'm not sure Darius Leonard's one of them. Did you see this? Darius Leonard is like fourth all-time in tackles with the Colts, and he's not even done with his fourth season.
That's crazy.
Have the Colts not tackled very much over the years? I don't know. So anyway, we're going to ask those questions. Nobody else is. Yeah, I mean, nobody else is going to ask those questions. I'm going to ask those questions in January. By the way, it's January. Somebody just asked me, hey, Dan, what does January mean? January means this. January means that you stop and think and try to be better this year. What does that mean, Dan? Well, here's what I'm putting on as guidelines. You ready? And join me on this. I already weighed in. I weigh a robust 250, which would be fine at 6'5", except it's all stomach. I'm going to lose weight. My goal is to be in the 230s by the end of January. I'm going to read 5 books. I've already read one. I read Kent Sterling's Oops book, which I got to tell you is a great read. All right? I'm going to do something nice for someone every day this week, every day this year. Today, I paid and wrote a check to a friend of mine whose wife has a cancer, and they need help. They've got to go to Houston, and there you go. So I'm going to pay for a lot of their stuff. So I'm 3 days in. Yesterday, I tipped a guy way more than I should, to the point where I got an alert from Capital One saying, hey, you tipped over 60% on a bill. I said, yeah, it's January, baby. Where's the big cat? The big cat was going to join me in January, and I haven't heard from him. I got to try to get him on tomorrow. If your name is Dan, you're in. It is. Dan, I'm starting my book, Permission to Dream, by Chris Gardner. I like it. I highly recommend, just go to Amazon. You can get Ken Sterling's Oops book. I swear to God, it'll keep you entertained and informative, and he is self-deprecating, and it's great.
Why should I get it, Dan?
I just told you.
Well, like, what's inside of it?
I told you. It's interesting, entertaining, informative, and self-deprecating. It'll tell you to learn from your mistakes.
There we go.
There you go. Which is a big deal. And it'll tell you what mistakes he made, and they're freaking hilarious. And I will argue this. I would argue that he at least sometimes when I was with him, he left some out. Dan, what do you think tonight? Steelers. I got the Steelers now -2.5. I'll take them. I'll take the Steelers -2.5. Last night, the Steelers were +3. I took that, too. I'll take the Steelers -2.5. I'll take them today, tomorrow, and the next day. And you know what? My toes are going to be tapping. All right, Eddie. I got to go clean up more coffee. Holy hell. What a mess I made. We'll be back.
Spectrum Mobile is reinventing wireless again. Get unlimited on 2+ lines for $29.99 a month per line. No contracts, no added taxes or fees. Includes nationwide 5G. Save up to 60% with Spectrum Mobile. Get unlimited on 2+ lines for $29.99 a month. Call 855-438-2999 or visit a store near you.
Offer valid for new customers on 2+ unlimited lines. Spectrum Internet required. Savings based on 2-line comparison of unlimited plans among major national carriers as of 9/2021. Prepaid excluded. Restrictions apply.
Referring a friend on FanDuel Sportsbook could be your ticket to Super Bowl 56. Hey, it's Mark from Kevin and Query, and that's right. When you refer a friend on FanDuel Sportsbook, you'll be entered for a chance to win an all-expenses-paid trip to Super Bowl 56 for two. Don't miss FanDuel's biggest refer-a-friend offer ever. All you have to do is share your exclusive referral link right in the Sportsbook app. Once your friend places any bet of $10 or more, you'll both get $50, and you'll be entered in the Super Bowl sweepstakes. If you or a friend have been thinking about joining FanDuel, now is the perfect time to give it a shot. I love betting on FanDuel Sportsbook. The app is easy to use. They have great offers every single day. And when you win, you get paid in as little as 2 hours. So download the FanDuel Sportsbook app and refer a friend for your chance to win a trip for two to Super Bowl 56. 21 and over and present in Indiana. Referred players must wager $10 or more within 28 days after signing up. Bonus issued is site credit and is now withdrawable and expires after 7 days. Restrictions apply. See terms at sportsbook.fanduel.com. No purchase necessary for the Super Bowl ticket promotion. Super Bowl promotion closes on January 9th, 2022. Gambling problem? Call 1-800-9-WITH-IT.
Wealth isn't simply about money. It's more than just the numbers in your portfolio or your bank account. Wealth is all the everyday things that money enables you to do, the goals you're after, things you want to accomplish, and the life you want to lead. So how do you get there? Tune in this weekend for Everyday Wealth with Soledad O'Brien and Gene Chatsky, presented by Edelman Financial Engines. Each week, award-winning journalist Soledad O'Brien and personal finance expert Gene Chatsky will explore how our financial decisions shape our everyday lives. They'll be joined by Edelman Financial Engines wealth planners and other guests to demystify challenges like tax-efficient investing, retirement planning, and more. They'll share knowledge and tools to manage your finances today and build wealth for tomorrow. Join the conversation. Everyday Wealth airs each weekend and will be available on major podcast platforms. For airtimes, visit everydaywealth.com.
Values have skyrocketed.
Which means even if you refinance in the last year, you can still save money with Golden Oak Lending's low 1.875% rate.
I'm James Hawkins, president of Golden Oak. With our low rates and your increased equity, you can make home improvements, eliminate your mortgage insurance, or pay off those holiday credit charges.
Woohoo!
Call 317-706-GOLD today and skip your first two mortgage payments.
And remember, if we can't close your loan, the appraisal is no charge.
Golden Oaks' low 1.875% rate is as good as money in your pocket. Call 317-706-GOLD today and start saving.
Golden Oak Lending cured my blues.
NMLS 114937. 1.875% fixed. 2.952% APR. FHA 15-year mortgage with 20% equity and approved credit.
Liberty Mutual Insurance Company presents.
And Doug.
Don't you just love the smell of old books?
This is a library.
Sorry, ma'am. We're looking for a book titled Liberty Mutual Customizes Your Car Insurance So You Only Pay for What You Need.
I don't think we carry that, but check nonfiction.
It really does devour literature.
Please leave.
Only pay for what you need.
Liberty, 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 liberty.
Doctors Without Borders teams confront hard facts in conflict and crisis zones. When others look away, we step in to act. Because measles still kills more than 100,000 children every year, we're there to vaccinate more than 1 million. Because some countries have only one or two mental health professionals, we provided over 400,000 mental health consultations last year. The fact is, your support makes our life-saving work possible. Picture the impact we can have together. DoctorsWithoutBorders.org.
Did you know Amazon provides ways of working that fit your lifestyle? They know you value your time outside of work, juggling family, school, friends, or other activities. That's why they offer a variety of shifts that work for you. There are full-time, part-time, and even temporary opportunities that can work with your schedule, with great starting pay and sign-on bonuses. If you want a career that fits and adapts to your lifestyle, head to Amazon.com/apply. Amazon is a proud equal opportunity employer.
Sports Center updates on the Fan are brought to you by Big O Tires. Stop by your locally owned and operated Big O Tires for the lowest price on every tire every day with financing options available. Big O Tires, the team you trust.
Join us on the Fan and listen to Jason Hammer on You Bet with Bet Rivers, 7 to 8 p.m. on Thursdays, where you can get all the betting advice you would ever need.
It's Kevin and Querry.
The Colts search for a playoff bid is going to be put on hold until week number 18.
Two ways to look at it, I guess. One is to be invigorated by the fact that you're heading down the home stretch and you're still in the playoff hunt, but the other is, man, opportunity missed.
That is the worst game the Colts have played since week 3. Here you are 2 weeks before the start of the playoffs, but at the same time, it's also kind of a compliment to how well they have played.
Kevin and Querry.
Weekday mornings at 7
on 93.5 and 107.5. The Fan. The Dan Dockett Show, 93.5 and 107.5. The Fan.
You know, it is interesting how quickly things turn. The Bills, remember, kind of left for dead. They lost to the Patriots at home 14-10 when the Patriots ran the ball every single possession. And then all of a sudden, the Buccaneers got them in a hell of a game down there. And then, you know, they were a little bit left for dead. They had lost 3 of 4. The Colts had beat the living you-know-what out of them. All of a sudden, the Bills have won 3 in a row. Seriously. Man. Let me ask you a question. This is interesting. And this goes back to anger. This goes back to coaching toughness. This goes back to in-building toughness. T.Y. Hilton said, and I'd be curious to ask T.Y. Hilton this. T.Y. Hilton said, hey, we didn't come out to play. We didn't come out to play. And I'm curious. See, you say that when you've got a soft regime. You don't ever say that when you got tough guys at the controls. You know what I mean? I mean, like, maybe you did, but you don't say it because you know somebody in that building is going to crush your soul for saying it. You know what I mean? And I don't know. I just wonder because let's be totally honest here. In big moments, and I guess, you know, the players and everybody's going to make this game with Jacksonville out to be a big moment, and it's going to be. But in big moments, this team has not exactly showered itself in greatness, this regime, against good teams. And I look at it and I say, wait a second. Is there anybody healthier than the Colts right now? You know what I mean? Is there anybody healthier than the Colts right now? And the answer is no. I don't think so. Is there anybody that has a better run game? Shouldn't be. The truth of the matter is, I don't, there's no excuse for what happened yesterday. Now, I like the Colts, and maybe I'm ready to go to Ballard's, you know, come to Jesus meetings that, you know, all these guys that carry water for him do. But I'll tell you this, I when I saw that from Hilton, I thought to myself, man, did anybody ever say that under Grigson and him? Now, I know you guys got to take a drink because I mentioned Grigson, but that's all right. But the fact of the matter is, let me put it to you this way. I just think it's very, very, very rare that anybody says that in modern day football. Because most football guys and most football media are so afraid to say that. You know, you don't want to say that. Well, I don't know, man. All I know is this. They didn't. They were flat. The defense didn't have any. What do they call it? Juice. We got to have juice. But they didn't. To start with, his 12-play drive, 7 minutes, they knocked the hell. I mean, absolutely knocked the living hell out of the Colts right from jump. Colts got back in it because that's what NFL teams do. It's not like, you know, this isn't the 72 freaking Dolphins, the Raiders. They got a nice team, but you know their lead wide receiver was? Zay Jones. You know where Zay Jones is from? East Carolina. Zay Jones, for whatever the reason, has become really good. I mean, I don't know if he's really good, but he had 10 targets, 8 catches, 120 yards. He's had 6, 5, 3. The guy's catching balls. Here's what I'm like. Come on, let's go. I thought maybe Doolin, or I thought maybe Patman, or I thought maybe the other guy would, Pascal, but nobody really stepped up. Nobody really yesterday. And again, you can blame it all if you'd like on Wentz. Sure, go ahead. It's easy. But that defense didn't step up. And they're such good dudes. Like, the way they handle the crowd is great. I mean, all that stuff is fantastic. But you got to, I don't know, man. When it comes down to it, you got to rush the passer. When it comes down to it, you got to get to the quarterback. When it comes down to it, and the Colts have been pretty good with this, you got to make a play. And sometimes making a play isn't late. Sometimes it's early. Sometimes it is early. And nobody made a play in that first drive. And I swear to God, Lee and I both said it. We're sitting there. We're watching. I'm like, you know what? It kind of feels like they're going to lose this game, even when they went up. I told Lee I thought we were going to overtime. I said, I ain't really going to lose or go to overtime. I think it's going to be overtime. And sure enough, Colts would have been helped had the touchdown counted. I would have been helped. I had the over 46.5. What do you got, Mark?
Danny.
How are you?
Hey, Kenny Moore was looking like Eugene Daniel yesterday, guarding Renfro.
That was tough. Renfro had his way with Kenny Moore.
Hey, Frank won't put JT in for more of passing?
I don't know. You know, they took him out a lot, which was, I mean, they gave him the ball. Don't get me wrong. But I don't know. I mean, I think he can catch the ball. Can he? I mean, what's he?
Oh, yeah,
I feel like I would put him in, and I don't give a damn. You know what I mean? Like, hey, if you can't catch, learn, but I ain't taking you out. Does that make sense?
Yeah, he wants to catch it more than run it, I think, at some point. But,
well, he's pretty good at running it after he catches it. I mean, we've seen some, you know, we really do.
He's the best.
Yeah, he's great. Danny. Appreciate you, Mark. No, he's great. But what you got to do, look, we got a whole week to talk about this, so I'll get into more of that as the week goes on. But I got to tell you, I'm just not 100% convinced that this team can play in big moments based on toughness. Now, hey, look, they went to the Cardinals and won, and that was a great team win, and they were due for a letdown. So I'm not going to be hard. I'm not being crazy. You know I can get crazy on this show. But, man, boy, Van Pasture, man, said it right. It's better to knock somebody down in football than to be all introspective. Yes. The Mike Tyson theory, no sport other than boxing, does the Mike Tyson theory of everyone has a plan until they get knocked in the mouth. I guess MMA and boxing. I guess those two things, right? But other than that, I mean, who really gives a rat's ass? Look, I don't blame, I guess we're all, aren't we supposed to, what do we do? We're supposed to blame Wentz, right? Okay, I mean, it's easy. All right. Wentz felt sluggish after testing positive for COVID, but doesn't see a connection. Played poorly in a possible playoff clincher after missing a week of practice, but doesn't see the connection. This is the Colts franchise quarterback. Yeah, it is. And regardless, man, regardless of what anybody feels, he's going to be. You can try to run him out of town all you like. That's fine, but who cares? I mean, Ryder, who cares? I mean, the only people that ever pay attention are when you write about me, so just do that. I mean, seriously, I mean, my wife had COVID. She been vaccinated. My kids had COVID. They've been vaccinated. They were sluggish. I mean, hey, people get COVID. Vaccinated, unvaccinated. What do you want me to do? They felt sluggish. What do you got, AJ?
Hey, thanks for taking the vine. Appreciate it. All right, happy New Year.
Same to you.
First off, not people say there's no good thing as a good loss, but scoreboard-wise, no. And physical expenditure that you got to put out to do it, no. But mentally, you know, I think it'll be it'll pay off in the long run. I really do.
What do you think? How so?
Well, you're not as good as you think you are. You're not as bad as you think you are. I think it's a good time to check themselves, you know, look in the mirror, take inventory, and go out there and take it out on the next opponent.
Yeah, and that's going to be that's the cliche. Appreciate your call. That's going to be the cliche, no question. We'll see if you do it. I mean, we'll see if you do it. Look, I get it. We're mad at Wentz. He didn't get vaccinated. The writers, the 90% liberal writers are trying to save the world. That's fine. I mean, but I've been vaccinated. I got sick as hell 2 weeks ago. I didn't have COVID. My daughter got COVID. Everybody in my family got COVID. Everybody's been vaccinated. I don't know. It's just easy. Look, so I'm not blaming that. Hell, everybody, you know what's going to happen. Everybody in college basketball's got COVID. Globetrotter, I'm kind of with you because, frankly, they're going to be a wild card. The only game that really matters is next week. And I anticipate the Colts playing well next week. And then they're going to get in the playoffs. And then it's going to be a matter of whether or not they win in the playoffs. And if they do, then you're going to be fine. If you don't, then no. I'll tell you one thing we do worry about in Indy, though. We do worry about a lot more than maybe any other place whose portrait is outside. Who's going to be the guy on the wall? Look, one thing we should only care about is winning. Dan, did you see this? I did. CNN, welcome to 2020, CNN. Listen to this. This is a big tweet from CNN, 7:15 this morning. Wow. People who are overweight or obese are at a much higher risk of much more severe disease and even death from COVID. Wow. A new study suggests, wow, welcome to 2020, CNN. Good for you. I think we all knew that, didn't we? I mean, the one thing that everybody asks me when I tell them a friend of mine or two has died from COVID is, well, what were the underlying risks? CNN, good for you. You're getting there. All these things that they've been spouting is showing to be false, and now they're coming around to, like, real science and real stuff. How about that? Good for CNN. Should we do this in grocery stores? Masks are highly recommended to slow down the spread of COVID is what I see in my grocery store. Well, shouldn't we also then put, hey, a healthy shopping list is also recommended for slowing down COVID? I feel like that would be a good thing But that would offend the biggins who are now being told in our world, it's okay to be big, fat, and overweight. It's okay. Right, Ed Rogers. Obesity is a killer. We'll be back.
With an easy refinance, our clients, on average, save over $350 a month. TheHomeLoanExpert.com.
NMLS number 1326241.
Join Mark Patrick Seminars and stop smoking now without cravings, irritability, weight gain, or your money back.
Totally changed my life.
It's amazing.
I don't have any cravings.
You want to quit but have found it impossible? This is the thing for you. I have absolutely no cravings. It's the darndest thing I have ever seen in my life.
It's not for entertainment. It's for results.
Do it. It works. Period.
You've tried everything else. You need to come and try this.
Only $49.99 guaranteed, because don't just cut down, but stop smoking. In addition, use hypnosis to lose all the weight and destroy unwanted cravings. Seminars Thursday, January 20th at the Holiday Inn Hotel in Carmel. Weight loss seminar 5:30 to 7:30 p.m. Stop smoking seminar 8 to 10 p.m. And Saturday, January 22nd at the La Quinta Inn and Suites Hotel in Indianapolis. Weight loss seminar 11 a.m. to 1 p.m. Stop smoking seminar 2 to 4 p.m. Only $49.99 guaranteed. More info at markpatrickseminars.com.
Hello, 2022. Kick off the year and say hello to fast and reliable internet from Xfinity. Listen to this. For only $20 a month for 12 months with a one-year contract. Now, score 12 times the speed with the same internet price when you add Xfinity Mobile. That's incredible speed at an amazing value, so you can keep new resolutions going strong. Plus, ask how you can get a $300 back and a 5G phone on us with Xfinity Mobile during the Xfinity Hello 2022 sales event. Don't wait. Go to Xfinity.com/sale. Call 1-800-XFINITY or visit a store today. I did. It requires paperless billing and auto pay with stored bank account. Ends 1/10/22. So get in there now. Restrictions do apply. New Connect Xfinity 50 megabits per second customers only. Equipment taxes and fees extra and subject to change after term. Regular rates apply. Compare Xfinity's Connect Internet and super fast internet with mobile discount. Let's go! Welcome 2022.
Hi, I'm Arielle Winter. If you're anything like me, your pets are not only your best friends, they're part of your family. American Humane, which has been rescuing animals like Cleo here for more than 100 years, has life-saving tips that can make a big difference before, during, and after disasters such as hurricanes, tornadoes, floods, or wildfires. So when disaster strikes, you want to be prepared to protect them. Be sure to microchip or tag your pets. Never leave them behind in a major crisis, and be sure to have an emergency kit ready in your home at all times with a pet crate or carrier, leash, blanket, ID, and medications, their water bowl, and 7 to 10 days worth of food. To find out how to protect your entire family during a disaster and help our best friends in their worst times, please visit AmericanHumane.org.
Housing discrimination. Would you recognize it and report it? These folks did.
My landlord said rent will be cheaper if we're friends with benefits.
Because I'm legally blind, a landlord questioned whether I'd be capable of maintaining an apartment.
Our real estate agent said a different neighborhood with people like us might better suit our family.
To learn more about housing discrimination, visit hud.gov/fairhousing. Fair housing is your right. Use it. A public service message from HUD in partnership with the National Fair Housing Alliance.
Do you need to hire? Then you need Indeed. Indeed has 135 assessments to help you find the right candidates fast. Visit Indeed.com/credit.
The Pacers head to New York to face the Knicks tomorrow night at 7 on 93.5 and 107.5 The Fan.
What you gonna do? You wanna get down? Tell me. What you gonna do? Do you wanna get down?
It's the Dan Dockett Show, 93.5 and 107.5, The Fan.
You know, it is about high time that the defense closes some stuff out. Wentz has erratic moments. He's always going to have them. And he can practice 100 times. He's still going to have them. The defense, however, does not close out games. I mean, I can go back to Tampa, Sunday, Oh, man, don't even get me started on the Ravens. You got to close out games, fellas, and I know that's hard. I know it's hard. But the truth of the matter is you got to do it. I mean, if you're going to be what is an elite defense, I will say this. I would love to see Darius Leonard. The catch he made yesterday, that dude could play wide receiver. A lot of people say they can play other positions. That dude, man. All right. AOC made it easier for me, Eddie. How about that? AOC came out and said all of her critics want to have sex with her. Yeah, AOC, that's how I feel. Yeah. If AOC can say it, why can't I say it? That's what I'm saying from now on. Every article that's written about me, I'm going to say, hey, wait a second. I'm like AOC. Everybody that hates me, writes about me, wants to have sex with me. Mary and Catherine Hamm. I did not know who Mary Catherine Hamm is. But Mary Catherine Hamm is with CNN. She got 250,000 followers. She made fun of AOC. I love it. She made fun. And Mary Catherine Hamm speaks for me. I've always felt this way, right? Everybody's always felt this way. Let me see if I can find it here. It's so good. Mary Catherine Hamm. She had a great line. She said this. I relate to AOC. Literally every criticism of me boils down to people disappointed they can't have sex with me. It is indeed a burden, but one I must bear. You guys on YouTube, everybody, man, woman, whatever, that criticizes me, they just want a little bit of this. They just want a little bit of Danny Lovin. According to AOC, who, by the way, was shown maskless in Florida, but that's fine. If I say it, then I want to have sex with her. Good for AOC. She's opened this up for all of us. From now on, any of you guys on Twitter that say, Dockage, I hate you. I hate you, Dockage. I'm just going to say it's because you can't have sex with me. That's because I'm married. AOC said it's all right, baby. Yeah. There you go. Who doesn't? Did you know this, Eddie? Hunter Renfrow and the Raiders have playoff deciding game on Sunday, the exact 5-year anniversary of his TD winning catch against Alabama in the national championship game. I don't know what that means, but he definitely looks like a guy that is a manager. And he is, you know what else the Colts lost to yesterday? You and I just saw it. He got him a perm, and freaking Derek Carr got him a perm. Derek Carr got a perm, and a guy with a perm just beat the Colts. I got a perm once. I couldn't have beaten anybody. Derek Carr grew out his hair, got a perm, threw to a guy named Hunter, and beat the Colts' ass. Come on. And then Hunter got a perm. I saw it. Hunter poofed up. He got a poof.
Maybe he's trying to look like Cooper Kupp.
He might be. Her name was, last name was Taylor. She was awesome. And she worked at Uptown Barbershop. And I'm like, hey, can you give me a poof? Because you poof, when you get a perm, you poof your hair up. It gets curly and it poofs. Do you get a perm?
No, this is all natural, baby.
All natural. I'm jelly. I am jelly. Derek Carr went from having the crew cut, and now he got the perm. Got beat by a guy with a perm and eyeliner. I don't know if that's eyeliner. He got weird eyes. What do you? Lee asked me that yesterday, right? Lee's like, is that eyeliner? I don't think so. I think he's got like deep set eyes, because I call it mascara, and I don't know the difference.
I have a cousin who's like the same way.
Really?
Yeah.
Remember the Undertaker?
Yep.
He looked like the Undertaker. He's got, if he could roll his eyes up. Yeah, Derek Carr was good, but man, he and Hunter Renfrow, I wonder if they went to the same spot. Man, oh man. Hey, Dan, thanks to CNN. Hey, you got congratulations there? Can you give CNN a congratulations? Good for CNN. Yeah, I agree, Derek. We got to give them a congratulations whenever you're ready. Yeah.
Really proud.
CNN figured it out. Obesity leads to other health complications. No kidding. Wait, you can't say that because the biggins have commercials. Don't be saying that. CNN figured it out, huh? figured out the COVID effect. Next thing you know what they're going to say? They're going to say it affects old people. Oh, what a breakthrough. I thought it only affected people that rooted for Donald Trump. Damn. A lot of guys have been saying what Joe Rogan and Clay Travis have been saying this for years, and now, All right. Okay. If you say so, CNN, good for you. The Indy Star will have it next. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Oh, here you go. Jay Voss. I'm not Dan, but Woody doesn't have the players he needs to acquire the identity needed. Oh, okay, Jay Voss. Okay. Hey, Dan, as part of Danuary, are we abolishing Biggins? No, I think as part of Danuary, we're going to bring Biggins back. I'm going to see if Jimmy can get Biggins going tomorrow. Dan, do you think COVID will go away before midterms? Ooh. Joe Biden said he had it covered. Maybe he does. I hope so. I don't want anybody to have it. But good for CNN. Hey, look. And don't hit me with, yeah, Duncan's here against the MAGA guy. No, and all of a sudden Fox News come out with it a year and a half later. I'd be making fun of them, too. I'm sorry, but that's just funny. I know we're supposed to celebrate obesity and we're supposed to celebrate unhealthy lifestyles. I'm not. Danuary is about weight loss, getting better, getting in shape, reading books, doing better for yourself. Well, what's the definition of doing better? Not being a fat ass like I currently am. That's the definition. Because right now, I'm 250, and I shouldn't be. I should be 220, and I don't want to be anymore, and I hope you'll join me. Let me know how much weight you lose. Let me know what good you do. That's right. That's right. There you go. All right. Whew. It's getting hot in here. Dan, did you really say if the Colts lose, you will do the show naked? I am. Dan, this is a pretty good picture. That guy, Gary Collins, that guy's also in Breaking Away. I was going to fight my buddy Worm because he said I looked like that guy. Same guy that was in Home Alone as one of the robbers. Yeah, he's got those deep-set eyes. He does. We'll be back at it 9 o'clock tomorrow morning. Show this morning was good. Show today was good. You guys make it good when we get some calls. Hey, Dan, from this particular show, Reggie Jones said that Dan would rule the world if he changed races and gender and get the haters to stop wanting to have relations. Danuary is rolling. That's right. AOC said it. So, Dan. Dave, I'm not reading that. I refuse to read that. I'm not reading that. We're all supposed to work remotely Friday. And Monday, because there's a lot of stuff going downtown. That, hey, Jeff Heidelag, I'm very happy for you, by the way. Jeff and Jerry Seesting are the two guys that have been on the Bengals on my ass. Seesting all the way from Naples the other day. And Jeff just gave money. He won money on the Bengals, and he gave money to our bikes program. So I'm a big fan of Jeff. Dan, what are you taking tonight? I'm taking Pittsburgh -2.5. And I already got Iowa -7.5. Eddie, you said it went to 9, right?
Yep.
Yeah. So I already got it 7.5, and my toes are going to be tapping tonight. Hey, Indiana, we'll talk more about them tomorrow. We'll get into more Colts stuff as they head to, well, I guess you would say that's the biggest game of the year. The Pacers are going to take on the Knicks. I just watched the 30 for 30 last night. Again, it's so good. Eddie, great work, kid. Have a wonderful afternoon to all of you. John will be next, and his show will be a hell of a lot better than this show just was.
It's Kevin and Querry.
The Colts search for a playoff bid is going to be put on hold until week number 18.
Two ways to look at it, I guess. One is to be invigorated by the fact that you're heading down the home stretch and you're still in the playoff hunt, but the other is, man, opportunity missed.
That is the worst game the Colts have played since week